Look at me now. Motherfuckers wanna talk shit. Make 'em burn it out. Make 'em burn it out for eternity. Fuck, 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 fuck.
It's okay, yeah.
What the fuck is this? What the fuck is going on?
Invalid command. Oh, plus make it P. Okay. Plus make it P. Oh, no.
Bro, is he... What is this?
Oh, no. I can't jump. Oh, no. Oh, my God. No way.
You're fucked, dude. Cat RP is over.
Oh my God. Ow.
There must be an emote. Bro, your cat RP is fucking done, son.
Please.
Manager at the casino and burger shop and vineyard. What the fuck?
Wait, there actually might be a way to fix this. Hang on. I know it looks creepy, but sometimes the dance can like move you a little bit.
Joe's fucking unemployed. Coils on Sos.
Let's push it, my dudes.
U-turn now. He might be heading. Stand by. We're gonna try to hurt him. Sorry, we're hurting him southbound now. Just keep those spikes set up. Keep those spikes set up.
What are we gonna do, chat?
Elgin just passed Torque Smasher on
what are we gonna fucking do? Auto got on right after I got off.
Should I call 911? No way!
Oh no, chat.
No way! Cat stuck in ditch. Is it not? Is it 301 or 911? I don't know.
All right, 1 second, chat.
My name is Tappy Nippers. Type slash E mechanic.
Okay.
Guys, what's I don't up? Think it's, I'm going to be able to get out.
No, you won't.
Like, you're all recommending emotes that make you move. But I think this curb blocks my movements no matter what the emote is, because the other ones would have worked otherwise.
You got so, fucked.
Unlucky. I actually just have to wait here or suicide pill. And I'd rather just wait. I think it's funny. I cannot go first person now. I don't think I can.
Okay. You know what? We're going to get on Joe and we're going to make some shit happen. We got some fucking work to do, okay? We got some work to do. We have to meet some people. We have to get in with the action. We have no more fucking around. By the way, welcome back, everybody. Thank you for being here. I love you guys. Pog, hey, look at that. We're just about to get back to 5,900 again. 6K. How's everybody doing? We had EU earlier. Now we're a little bit NA. EU's probably going night-night. Nighty poo-poos, little shit-shit chans. Good to see you guys. Let's hop into some NoPixel, baby. Wait, chat. Are you still here if you're EU? Type one of your EU and still here. Hmm. Looks like all the EU boys went night night. Looks like they went night night. Oh damn it. And I'm tuned in place. Oh my god. I'm falling off. I am washed up. We gotta get in, baby. Chat, all you EU people, go to sleep, guys. Space Kid 99. Arigato gozaimasu.
11 months, punk.
Bro, I'm such a good girl. Well, while we're waiting, we might as well just catch up on some fucking pod content. Let's see how XQ Cal is doing. Come on.
Differences.
Oh,
guys, anything too friendly is not gonna work.
He's
out.
On the. He's on the. Better. He's on the threesome one.
You know, it's interesting how
this is where you can pull out a gun. Right?
Everyone's got a different personality.
Spice it up, dude.
Different look. Like Denise, she's kind of more reserved, but then she's got the wild side. And already.
Please.
Chance, just get out of there, dude.
Come on.
You're gonna have to relog.
I'm gonna do a whole stream in this ditch. Please. Ooh, it's right here.
Mess, hello. I hear it.
Can you talk as a cat?
Oh, it is.
Aw.
Wait, let's talk to it.
Don't worry, I got the cat.
Stop!
It's fine. Aw.
Oh my god. All right, things we need to get done on Joe.
My boss.
Listen, I'm gonna keep it real with you. Yeah. Check it. What? Yeah. Check it. Yo. 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 Check it. 50 Shades of Grey. Feel it now. Hey chat, Nani the fuck? Fuck in America, in America, in America, yeah. Okay. Weebs. We have booze and full current stop lights. Chat, it's you guys. Hiya, Yon, chat. Jager! 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 I mean, that's not too bad.
Room 420. Yeah.
Hey, you.
Me?
Yeah, you. Do you like anime?
Yeah.
Do you want to do something fun with your life?
Not really, but yeah.
Then you should come to room 100 after school from 2:30 to 3:30.
Room 429?
My balls!
Room 100, you moron, for anime club.
I mean me.
No! So are you going to tell your friends and are you going to show up and have a good time?
Yeah.
Now, do you like
my balls?
Wait, is she part of Vigor's whoop, whoop gang?
Do you like anime? Now, do you
oh,
like
they're part of Vigor's group.
Anime?
Yeah.
Yo, this is so kawaii, desne, chat. I mean, as long as they're happy.
See ya, Boojas.
I may be the new guy, a part of the Akatsuki.
Ah, I know. I use my newest jutsu. Fast forward jutsu.
Go right.
I'm not gonna lie, this is the shit that I love from high school.
Shadow clone jutsu!
No, stop.
Shadow clone jutsu!
What the?
There he is!
Okay. I think we're done here. Alexa? Set an alarm for 35 minutes from now.
Alarm for what time?
35 minutes!
35 minutes.
Yes.
Starting now.
Thank you. Stuck in America, in America, in America, whoa! Here we go. Let's do some good old-fashioned role play. Oh shit, hold on. You know what? Fuck this shit.
Someone left a dead animal in here, sweet.
Mm-hmm. gonna RP this with dignity, okay? Alright. I'm not gonna put any music on right now. Let's just fucking get on. Let's get to it. Alright? I need to think of a very clever way to weasel my way into some good RP. Four thirsty customers at the Rooster's. At the Rooster's Rest. Hello, I will go to Burger Shot. What does that mean? Let's get to Rooster's Rest. Taxi. William Murderface. What the fuck? Pogo.
Hello, Motorface Motors.
Hi, I'm at the apartments. I was wondering if you could come pick me up. Thank you.
Yeah, where do you need to go?
I need to go to the Rooster's cock.
The cock? What do you mean?
The Rooster's cock.
The Rooster's cock. Got it.
Yeah, the Rooster's cock.
All right, how much you want to pay me?
How much do you want?
I don't know what that was acceptable.
How does $100 sound?
$100? All right, I'll be there.
Oh, wait. You sounded too exciting.
All right, $500.
Whoa, what the fuck? Hey.
What? Yeah. You said, now you sound excited.
No. I'm not excited. I'm displeased.
Okay, $98.
There we go, deal.
All right, bet.
I love you.
All right, see you in a minute.
I know, I'm treating him like old Joe, dude. It's old habits. Old habits die hard.
Yeah, oh, you're calling for a ride.
Murderface?
Yeah, what's going on, man?
This is your taxi?
Yeah, you're borrowing it.
You're borrowing it? What do you mean you're borrowing it?
From the taxi service.
Okay.
It's a high-class taxi service. It's, you know, riding style, exclusive.
Okay. All right.
I mean, you want to ride with style, right? You don't want to show up in
Yes, I want to ride with style. Yeah, it's actually very, very... You know me well, don't you?
Yeah, I could tell from your voice that you are a man of esteemed quality products and services.
Well, I appreciate that analysis from you. It makes me feel really good about myself.
Oh, well, you're welcome, man. It's my pleasure, you know, in Motorface Motors Taxi Service to... please the customer in all ways possible.
Yeah.
Except blowjobs. I don't do that.
It's okay. I don't want head from you. Do you have cocaine?
I was literally just about to ask you the same question.
I don't have cocaine.
Do you know where we can get some cocaine?
Nope. Not yet.
I got like 9 joints on me if you want some weed.
You'd give me some weed?
I mean, it's a, you know, an included service, so it, you know, I'd raise the price a little bit.
Okay. I mean, to be fair, I am paying you $100. Let's get some fucking weed.
All right, sure. I'll give you a joint, and you can just pay me the $100 for the ride. And
okay, there we go. Easy
call
done.
Call me later.
All right, Murderface.
Yeah, so what you doing at the Rooster?
It's the only place I know to go to meet people. I'm using it as a social tool.
Yeah, you should get my number totally in case you find some cocaine as well.
Okay, well... Well, I'll be sure to let you know.
Yeah, totally. All right, let's pull over here.
Oh, I appreciate you didn't drive over the median like that. The
well,
last
I
driver
told
did.
You, quality, you know.
Yep. All right, let me pay you up, okay?
Yeah, sounds good. If you want my number, I can give it to you as well.
386.
Hey, go around!
There you go. There's your 100.
All right, thank you. You want my phone number by chance?
Sure.
All right, it's 628. Oh, wait, you got it in the yellow pages, don't you? You can just save it.
Yeah, I got you. Hey. All
right, cool. Have a good day, sir.
Can you hook me up with that weed?
Oh, yeah. Here, let me jump out.
Yeah, I love weed. Mm-hmm.
But this thing doesn't have a good glove box.
Oh, okay, fair enough.
Oh, this place is really nice, actually.
Thank you so much.
All right, there you go, man. Yep. Smoke up. Oh, God, there's a cop right there. All right, have a good day, sir.
Hey, you drive safe, all right, Murderface?
Yeah, it's not my car, actually. I'm not driving.
All right, I didn't hear that.
Hey, they got any food in here?
We're about to find out, aren't we? Well, what kind of situation is going on over here?
Sir, is this your car? You should probably get it fixed, then.
Officers! I just want to thank you for keeping the streets clean over here.
I took it to a very windy place, and they ended up...
Chicago!
Alright, man, have a good one.
Alright. Joe loves the cops. No, he hates the cops, but he sucks up to them.
Yeah, let's get a police shot from dispatch real quick. Come over here, Tete. Come over here. Read the plate for me real quick. Alright.
Stuck in America. Holy tabs. I know. But guess what? I got a boss-ass computer, okay? So I'm all right. All right? We're good. Capiche?
All right, jump. That's spider.
Oh, shit.
You know what we're gonna do? Let's throw ourselves out there. Okay? Come on! Alright. We're 24935.
Time to throw PogChamp.
My balls!
Time to throw pog champ.
Okay, let's think. Huh. Yo, Z Kenny, my dude, thank you very much for the 22 months, big pog.
Oh, hello.
Chat, help me word something. A networking tweet.
How are you doing?
A good networking tweet. But we are targeting a demographic of people that are smart, high-class business.
Yeah, this place is... Pardon me.
Excuse me.
That's just Yeager. He's complaining about something.
Lil Irv, is a casino opening tonight? That's what Lil Irv says. Business professionals. Can I speak to your manager? Read what you type, please. What are you talking about? Bro, I wish I could swipe these notifications out of the way. What do you mean? Looking to make rich friends and rich friends only. Phone number. Yes, that is what I tweeted.
And also, chips.
Absolutely, come in right up.
Thanks.
Bro, I need some socializing. Hey, what's up?
Not much. How are you doing? Good looking.
Oh, not much. I'm just fucking chilling.
Just chilling?
Yeah.
In line for food? What are you trying to get, bro?
What am I trying to get? I don't know yet. I've not made that decision yet. Maybe
that's
Granny's mac and cheese?
Man, I had their mac and cheese. All right. Their ramen's pretty good. They only do like a beef tonkatsu though here.
A beef what katsu?
Tonkatsu. It's like a bone broth thing.
Oh, that's really cool.
Yeah.
Like that.
I don't know what their noodles are here though. They're kind of chewy. Maybe they're like an egg noodle.
Yeah.
I'm Nico. What's your name, bro?
My name is Joe.
Pleasure to meet you, Joe.
Yeah, it's a pleasure to meet you too.
I dig the aviators. Sunglasses inside is always a move, you know?
Yeah. I don't like how my eyes look.
Same, not gonna lie. Too sunken for me, you know?
Yep.
Had a real coke binge.
Yep. Well, I'm gonna go have a smoke outside.
Mind if I bum a cigarette off you, bro? Just chill if not, bro. It's fine.
Sure.
All right, sick, yeah. Cool if I join you, or you just like to smoke solo?
Yeah, you could smoke with me.
You're giving me the whole pack? I mean...
Yeah, that's the kind of man I am.
Holy shit.
I don't fuck around.
Kind of, what do you smoke, bro?
What do I smoke? Marlboro Reds?
Same
as my father, my father before him.
Your forefathers?
Yes.
So you from around here, bro?
Yes. I'm from Polito. I was born and raised.
Oh yeah, how's that?
Well, I've not been there for a while. I've been traveling the world.
Yeah, where'd you travel to?
Switzerland, all over the world, Italy.
Oh, same, bro. Yeah, I just did a fucking, Euro tour. Skating Europe and shit.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, part of the Bratwurst tour. It was sick.
Yeah.
Yeah. Went through, like, Germany, Amsterdam, Switzerland. Sick-ass spots.
Did you make a lot of money?
Skating really isn't too much money. It's mostly just kind of the lifestyle. I mean, you got sponsors taking care of you.
Yeah.
And, I mean, free drugs, though. It's sick, you know.
That's pretty...
Amsterdam was really where it's at, you know?
Okay.
Did a lot of acid. Really cultured myself. That's why
what,
I grew
drugs?
My hair out.
Drugs?
Yeah.
Hey, do you know where I can find some fucking cocaine?
You know... I've been kind of trying to kick the coke binge, you know, that was 3 months of just taking a fucking break.
Okay.
But, oh, I shit you not, though. I do want to get back into the Molly game.
The Molly game? Oh, I don't fuck with Molly.
You don't like to party?
Not that kind of party.
You just like to get fucking really wired?
Yep.
Just white knuckle shit?
Yeah, I like railing lines of coke off of chicks' tits.
Oh, yeah?
Yep.
Just, like, that's just the start of the night for you, or does it just end from there?
Well, preferably I would start the night and end the night. Maybe even do it in the middle.
Just a consistent railing coke off of tits.
Yeah. No intention of sleeping with these women, just...
No.
Just, absolute. It's a thing. It's the... It's the fucking thing, you know?
Yeah, I get you. I mean, yeah, like when you're partying, yeah, sometimes I like to, I mean, when I was skating a lot here and doing coke. Yeah, yep. I put it on my board.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
It just made me feel grounded to my lifestyle, you know?
Yeah.
It's like, yeah, it's a fucking different thing.
You have a woman?
Do I have a one?
A woman?
A woman? Yeah, I'm dating this girl named Lily.
Lily?
Yeah, she's pretty cool. You know, after winning like a regional tournament, getting some money to go to fucking Europe and shit, I paid for her ticket, took a 23 in me, and I found out I'm Japanese and German. Who would have fucking known?
You're Japanese and German? That's crazy.
Yeah. Yeah. Don't really know my dad or anything, but my new adoptive father is a terrorist, whatever.
A terrorist?
Yeah. Have you ever heard of this organization called Al-Qaeda?
Al-Qaeda?
Yeah, when you hear like helicopters and planes fall out of the sky, it's kind of his doing.
No, I've never heard of Al-Qaeda, but now I know.
Yeah. Great guy. Loves plaid. Big oxy addict.
Okay.
But just loves blowing shit up, you know?
Okay, alright.
What about you? You got a woman?
It's been a while. It's been a while, dude.
It's interesting, you know. It's hard to rail.
Evening officers.
Lines of coke. Hola. Hello.
I love cops.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You kind of cramped my style, you know. The skate stoppers everywhere, just cramping down on
just
my.
Just kidding.
Life.
As far as I'm concerned, they can go get fuck themselves.
Yeah, fuck 12 kind of thing.
Yeah. But here's the thing. I like acting like I like them.
I mean, it's kind of like Robin Big, you know. You do need some kind of necessary evil, so if you gotta pretend to like them.
Exactly. Well, if you can trick them, if you can trick them, then you're technically, you have the upper hand, right? You're manipulating the dumb fucks.
Yeah, that's what I say all the time. Like, oh, just one more try. Give me 5 more minutes. I'll land it here. And then when they turn their back, it's just like, they drive off. I don't fucking leave. I'm just gonna fucking chill there.
Exactly.
Boof my claw.
Exactly.
Right, have a good day,
but
man.
I tell you what, each and every single one of them can go fuck themselves.
What the fuck you just call me?
It's a compliment, bro. You're gonna tell me that movie was bad?
That's not who I am, though.
But the mullet.
Well, it's not really. I mean, it's a mullet, but yeah.
Take it as a compliment, bro. It's. I like that movie. That guy's great.
Yeah, relax.
All right.
Have a good night.
Some people, you know.
Yeah, I remember when I was insecure, but then I wanted to get laid.
Dude, that's my whole lifestyle, you know. Just landing bolts down every day, you know. Just fucking full send.
You know, I usually smoke Marlboro Reds, but these are actually American Spirit Yellows, and they last for like 13, 14 minutes. Jay Mike!
Yeah.
Thank
then
you very much.
Sometimes I just kind of like just put it to my mouth and really don't do anything with it.
Yeah. That's sort of what my ex-girlfriend did.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I put it to her mouth and didn't really do anything with it.
Oh, wow. Oh. What, is she Kim Kardashian? Just only worked the tip?
Nah, she just wasn't really interested in it. So I was like, okay, well, we don't need to do that. We can have good old-fashioned Christian missionary-style sex.
That's cool. You put shirts on and turn the lights off.
Uh-huh. And then we play Enya in the background.
Only time?
Yep.
Yeah. You know, I woke up fucking shirtless. Just fucking coke all over my face. Listened to a Deep House remix of that once.
Oh, yeah. I've heard that one. It's pretty good.
Yeah. I just caught in a trance, you know?
Yeah. One time we were, No, oh, never mind. I don't know if I can say that.
You're safe here, bro. It's a safe space.
No. I don't know if I can say it.
Wait, so if you're saying you're not insecure and you want to get laid, how come the whole eye thing still bugs you, bro?
Oh, I just know my strengths and weaknesses.
Damn, you're that secure with yourself. You know your insecurities.
Yeah. It's completely reasonable to be realistic with yourself and say, hey, you know what? I got ugly ass eyes.
Yeah, you know? Yeah, it's like the whole thing, everyone goes around here saying they have a big dick. I just like to say mine's just average, you know?
Speak softly and carry a big dick. You know what I mean?
Yeah. But at the same time, you know, everyone's just fucking overwhelmed with, like, I have a massive fucking dick. I got a fucking hammer. It's kind of fucking, it's good to hear when someone's just like, you know.
Did you just hit my fucking car?
I'm average.
Oh my God, Vigor.
Holy shit.
Oh. That was violent. Hey, is everything okay?
You guys good?
I am...
Oh, dude, Skrillex.
Hey, everything's fine.
Why don't you tear that guy a new asshole?
Well, you know, I was probably in my right to, but I, probably bad for business, killing someone on top of our building, sirs. I hope you guys are okay. Is everything fine?
Oh, we're
kind of startled.
Yeah, thrilling night.
Someone was yelling, hitting someone's car, and I was just like, Jesus.
Yeah, he's out of here. I wish I could have noticed who that was, but my perception was just way too low.
Hey.
Your perception?
Your perception?
Yes, sir. Yeah, yes, sir.
Like prescriptive glasses or what?
No, I rolled low on my perception check. I didn't notice him.
Oh, would you roll like a fucking a
snakes,
9?
Snakes and ladders.
No, it's a D&D 5th edition. I rolled a 3 out of 20.
I'm a fucking dumbass. Sorry. I get them mixed up.
Okay. Yeah, I guess they're kind of similar. I mean, there's snakes in both.
What kind of class are you, bro?
I'm a level 12 Hexblade Warlock, Dark Elf.
I know it's Dungeons & Dragons, chat. I'm just
a man of fucking culture. You
know? A little bit of the RP.
Yeah. I mean, what can I say? Hexblades are pretty cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know.
Well, sirs, there's only 2 people working, and I really go in there, so. Sorry for all this commotion. What's up, Mr. Kane?
Do you guys... I mean, I'm gonna keep it real with you. Is it what you see? Was it what you get up there?
What do you mean, sir?
I really want to rail a fucking fat line of coke off of some naked chick's tits right now.
Oh, well, sir, we don't have that in here.
Alright, well...
But I could get you a churro or something.
A churro? A fucking churro?
Yes, sir. There's powdered sugar on it.
I mean, that's true.
Yeah, but who wants to play pretend all the time, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's for losers.
Yeah.
Mr. Kane, if you'd like a food item that's on the house, I've been instructed to be very kind to you.
Yeah, you know what? You guys have been incredibly kind. And you know what? I've gotten a lot of items on the house from you guys. I'm not going to accept those anymore. I'm paying for everything.
Wow.
Well, sir, just, I mean, again, it's very appreciative, but you don't have to.
Hey. Well, sir. What's your name again?
Jaeger Demon Blood.
Jaeger, thank you very much for the amazing service.
No, thank you, Mr. Kane. Jeez.
Yeah, send it up tell the people that they've only been incredibly kind. Tell your manager, the guy with the hat, the mask.
Yeah, Lando.
Yeah, so.
Oh, absolutely, Mr. Kane. Thank you so much. And your name, sir?
I'm Nico. Nico Canto.
Oh, Nico Canto. Well, I'm sure you're just as cool as Mr. Kane here.
You don't have to say that, bro. I mean, listen, this guy's kind of like a real estate agent. You know, he just knows people. He gets into fucking restaurants right away. Gets shit on the house. I'm just a young shredder, bro. Just trying to sell my boards and teach people the fucking flow.
Well, you know what it is? What I've analyzed about this town before you go in, Vigor, and I know you have to rush in there real quick because you're short-staffed. I realized, despite what people think about this town, if you treat people decently enough, they'll treat you with decency back. What's the problem with that?
I don't know, Mr. Kane. I'll say that...
You know, I apologize. Yeah. You really remind me of a friend in Italy.
Yeah, I get that a lot, actually. Fuck! Sirs, I really need to go cook. I gotta go sear up some steaks, so I hope you guys have a wonderful night tonight.
Yes, yeah, thank you, Jaeger.
Is Nino still around here, bro?
Not tonight. I think it's just me and a few other staff.
He told me to talk to one of your managers for an event.
There's no managers here.
Okay, no problem, bro. Sorry for bothering you, dude.
No, sorry for having that freak up on the roof. I hope you guys have a wonderful night.
All right,
just execute him next time. Gladiator style. Hold him by his fucking hair and just go into
him, 1-2-2, Jimbo, thank you for the 20 months.
I appreciate that, but I don't think I can do that.
I think you could. As a Hexblade Warlock, you could.
He just really reminds me of my friend.
Oh, yeah? What do you remind you of? About the friend, exactly.
Just this dude. Same voice. Same sort of demeanor, but completely different dude.
It just sucks, man, for the working class here. You know, they don't have no right to defend themselves. Puggy, you know, they just have to fucking bend to the will of the man.
Hey, if I had things my way, I would help.
Why not run for mayor, bro?
Oh, I'm not a politician.
You're just so personable, you're so charismatic, I just thought you would be.
Well, you know, I feel like you lose that when you become a politician, the realness.
That's true. However, you could be one of the cool politicians and do lots of cocaine.
That is true.
I mean, who would not want to be that kind of politician? You know, you have a reggae band at your inauguration.
Mm-hmm.
Rail a line of coke off of the book you
exactly
signed on. You would probably go in on the book of like a Playboy, huh, or something.
Yeah.
Because you read the articles.
Yep. That's me.
Yeah.
That's absolutely me.
I can see it. It's in the shirt, you know, the way you carry yourself, the hairstyle.
Hey, you may have said it. What do you do here in town? Are you still a skater?
It was strict laws around here. I kind of own a skate shop. I sell boards. I got a board press. And I give BMX lessons, teach these shredders really how to fucking put it down, you know, fucking how to ride safely,
okay,
but also kind of fucking get the girls.
Get the girls?
Or guys.
Okay.
Girls or guys, however you flow. I don't care.
Okay.
But yeah, you know, holding a competition on this weekend, you know, I spoke to Nino about some kind of like sponsorship because Burger Shot said they were going to skull fuck the competition, how they're so much better.
That place is no good, right?
About it. No, I saw someone shit behind the counter there.
Okay.
A good friend of mine, actually. It was fucking sad, you know.
Okay.
She was at the strip club, you know, dancing with confidence, and then now she's working at a Burger Shot and they tell her what to wear and put her in her place all the time and she shits behind the counter, so.
Okay.
Shows you what their management is, and their manager looks like Rob Zombie, so.
Well, that's no good.
No. I mean, Rob Zombie's great, but as a manager, to speak to someone personally would be kind of scary.
Yeah. I would say so. Oh, you know what? I won't fuck with that place. I've only heard really bad things about it, so that's
yeah.
That.
Lots of weird poop shit. Apparently, they sell human meat there.
Ooh.
Ooh, you fancy yourself a little bit of flesh?
No.
Okay.
It was just a joke.
Oh, well, you never know. Some people are just into that shit here. That's why people still eat there, you know? They eat at a corporate conglomerate, you know, Burger Shots at every corner.
Yeah, I suppose you're right. Fucking wackos. Well.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, dude, this town is full of psychopaths.
Listen, dude, I dig you, dude. I think you're a cool dude. You know, I make skateboards. I make custom print boards. You gave me a cigarette. So, listen, if you ever want to be on a board or you want to take a photo shoot, we have fucking photographers at the shop. We'd love to fucking put you on a board.
Okay, that sounds like a lot of fun. Just throw me over your number.
Yeah. My number is 415-833-3851.
Fuck! I'm already out of fucking food, dude.
Yeah, you know, got a great group of dudes. All different personalities they bring to the table.
All right, and your name is Nico?
Yeah, Nico Canto. NicoKanto. Some
okay.
People like to spell it with a K, but I'm different.
Okay.
Listen, bro, I really hope you find your coke plug, and if you do, let me know. I wouldn't mind to do a bump one more time.
All right, that'd be great. I'll send you over a text message.
Yeah, thank you.
You can let me know what's up.
Yeah, I can tell you're a man of high decor. You know, you're from.
See, chat. Joe is just a
traveling.
Joe is
and,
just
you know,
a chat killer.
These boards you can hang up in your house, and you know what is a better way to capture urban art than with a skateboard?
Yeah, you're
you know?
Right. You're right. Well, I look forward to doing a little bit of skating. Hey, do you have anything to eat?
No, I don't. I was going to come here to eat, but then got caught up in conversation, bro.
Okay.
You want to sit down and get something to eat? I don't mind buying.
No,
you know,
no,
I got
no,
a
I'm
couple
good.
Of cash on me.
I got to get out and about.
All right, bro. Have a good one.
Yep, it's been nice, dude. Thank you
pleasure,
very much.
Dude. Yeah, have a good one, dude.
Yep. Oh, I got to turn off the heat, dude. It's way too fucking toasty.
Bro, what the fuck? 75 degrees in here.
75 degrees. What the fuck? I don't change it to that. All right, thank you. I'm gonna head out for a bit.
Hey, no problem. Thank you, Mr. Kane.
Yep. Dude, we need to find something to do other than this place. Like, how do we fucking network? Not a single phone call. Nobody's interested. Not a single phone call.
My balls!
Phenopoly, thank you very, very, very much for the 15 months. Is there a car show? Burrito van. There's no Coke as far as I'm concerned. And I don't know how to do deliveries. I actually don't know where, I don't know where deliveries are. Let me just open this door and let some hot air out.
Casino's not open.
I mean, I did roll Joe to get involved with the casino. That's the thing. And this is the only place where you can really interact with people. I mean, inevitably, we're going to have to find a way. A demeaning way for Joe to have a job. I more so would have liked to RP my way into a job position. Rather than get one of the, like, you know, the jobs that don't really suit Joe's character. And we're on fucking foot everywhere. Alexa, quiet. Alexa, set an alarm an hour from now. All right, chat, it's ad time, baby. Listen, you're, all of you non-subs, you're not gonna go down and, you're not gonna go down in vain, okay? You're not gonna miss anything. I need somebody. Ooh. Sorry about that, Joe. Hit me up when you get back around, okay? Gomer remembers Joe. But see, that's awkward. Because if Gomer remembers Joe, then Gomer would assume that Joe runs the vineyard, which he doesn't. And the owners of the vineyard have no idea who Joe is. So do we just ignore that? All beasts are gone, only good things can be remembered. All right, 17 hours ago. I'll just roll that up. I was out of town. And it got taken over. All caps, go see the kitty cat at Burger Shot. Okay. We need to get a car, man. We need to get a mode of transportation. I just refuse to have Joe Kane riding around on a BMX bike. It's like, that's that just kills the character. So we just have to play it cool until we can get a vehicle. So you can rent a car? Can you really? Oh, that's meta? I thought it was just something that you could find on the map. I got a lucky vehicle for free. Joe didn't exist. Joe didn't exist when all that happened. And it sucks because 2 months ago, Coyle asked me if I had any plans for Joe. He's like, I'll give you what you need. And I wasn't planning on bringing him back at the time because I didn't think he was going to refit into the server. I didn't think Otto was going to exist again. But I'm just... Oh, I've already talked to him, OOC. I mean, we know what we want to do. But this Joe Kane running around the streets with nothing to do needs to stop. And if we call a cab, we still don't know where we're going. Bro, shut the fuck up, dude. You are so fucking annoying. Yeah, I mean, it's midnight. We honestly might just have to wait until the casino's available. It sucks, dude. I want to do some networking on this character. We threw a phone number out. No hits. I mean, we met some people, but it's just not the right timing yet. Because effectively, we need to get in contact with the right people that can make things happen. It just be that way sometimes, chat.
Well, that was fucking easy.
Casinos are only open on the weekends. Yeah, we're gonna have to take a break from Joe. It sucks, but he's just not fitting in right now. And no bites from the tweet. running around everywhere in any GTA RP server sucks. Yeah, it does. Zorda wins. That is not going to happen. That is literally not a situation that's going to happen. No, I was never doing that. Why would it make sense for Joe Kane to do that? Yeah, I'm literally gonna have to fucking time it until the casino's open. Joe is useless. Joe is useless until the casino's available. So, I'm not gonna try until. No, I'm not gonna ask Coyle to set Joe up. That's unfair.
Body is a temple.
I'm going to RP into it. Vineyard is a great spot for RP to blossom. Not really. Not at this point. I mean, even when the server was populated before, people didn't want to go all the way up there. It sucks because if you went somewhere other than Roosters, you could meet more people. Yeah, but there's no indicators on Twitter, nothing of where to go. And I'm not going to ride around in a taxi cab and try and go fucking location spotting. It's just that's not what we're going to do. So. And we're not going to do race RP either. No.
This is my car.
All right, let's get going. haven't seen you with the CG boys, it's because I want to RP with new people. That's all it is. Hey, Simi, thank you very much for the 5 gifted subs. Big Pog, thank you. Thank you.
At the YMCA, Dito did free throws. Dito was trying to drop some pounds. Dito on keto. Dito was way too damn cute. I might eat him up. Dito burrito. Wakes up with Sunny when Dito is free though. That's why I call him Dito DeVito. Dito on Dito. 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 Playing with Dito on Meebo. Dito on Dito. Dito on Dito. Dito on Dito. Dito on Dito.
Undito, undito, undito. Undito, 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 undito. Undito, undito. I put Dito on top of a Dito. Then I put Dito on Dito, undito. Undito, undito, undito. Yeah. It's 720. Is this blurry? Undito, undito, undito. Undito, 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 undito. Undito, undito, undito. I put Dito on top of a Dito. Then I put Dito on Dito, undito. Undito, undito, undito. Okay. Well. Dito, undito. Why are you not being yourself? What do you mean? Oh, you mean Joe? I switched. There's Joe RP is dead right now. That's it. There's nobody for him right now. I'm gonna pee real quick. 1 second. Yeah, that bike is the bike fob is really funny. Alright, be right back. Pee time.
How's it going? Nice, me too.
We're back. Bada bing, bada fucking boom.
Still the best streamer, can't do this all the time, but what? Wanted to give.
Why does this shit look so fucked up? Okay.
How's it going?
Not bad. How are you?
Not bad. I'm just hanging out. Seeing what was going on.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, that's Gog.
I've never heard that word before. What does it mean?
It means good. It's my own accent.
Hey, gentlemen.
Oh, how's it going?
It's going well.
Well, good. I gotta go clock into work. I'm late.
Oh, no. All right. Well, I'll be hanging out.
All right. Later, loser.
That wasn't very Joseph Smith L of you.
I don't know what that means.
That's okay.
There you go.
Right.
Get the glory to the cock meal.
Fucking vigor.
Hey, Silver.
Hey, how's it going? Did I miss anything?
Nah, today's been pretty slow. I don't even think we made an opening tweet.
Oh,
and
no.
Half our party's doing a fucking raid.
Oh, really? What do you mean?
Yeah, Johnny Silverhand came up and had like a bus, like literally a bus full of people, and I think like eight of our party members, no, not eight, like five of our party members jumped in it.
Really?
And yeah, I was in it, and then I jumped out halfway because we were opening, and also, I can't stand hearing, you know, it's gonna be too many voices, I'll start freaking out.
Yeah, I'm the same way. That's why I left yesterday.
Were we at work or something? I don't remember yesterday quite often.
Oh, we were hanging out with Shadowfuck.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Too many people from my brain.
A wardrobe was added to the rooster?
That's cool. Nope, I didn't cock in yet, but you said it was slow, so maybe there's not even any point.
No, go cock in. I think we get some,
magically. All right.
Who got fired? Cell phone with what? What? Cocked in. Oh, fucking of course. Now Nino shows up. Now that I'm on Uchi. Not like this. Not like this. It sucks having to take a week off. I feel like I missed out on all the good RP. I feel like I have the RP FOMO chat.
I don't need the GI, I just wanted the vodka.
But you paid for a tea, sir.
But it is what it is, that was the world.
Mm-hmm.
instead of looking for a quest, why not being a quest giver? Because that's not really my role. I don't really have the ability to do that. What am I fucking... What am I looking for? Back to YouTube? No. Fuck no. Chat, it simply might just not be my day. It just might not be my day.
I look fine. I look fine, you old fuck. You geriatric old little bastard.
You look like you fell out of a dumpster and someone kicked you out of there because you couldn't go to the
hey, fucko.
Policy of the dumps.
Hey, fucko.
Welcome to the rooster.
Thank you. Long time no see. Where you been?
Well, I'm just chilling here. I work here.
Oh, okay. Interesting.
Yeah.
Well, listen, if you ever want to chill sometime, here's my number. I got a new phone recently.
Wow, that's pretty cool. Thank you. I'll be sure to send over a text message.
Yeah. All right, good seeing you. I'm going to go inside.
All right. Chat, you guys need to get rid of this whole fantasy of Joe terrifying Kevin Whippaloo. It's not a thing. All right? It was a meme at first. That was a hallucination of Kevin. That's the only reason why it was done. And that's it. There's no terrorizing Kevin Whippaloo arc.
Hello.
Hello. Oh yeah, we need food.
I came here to talk to you. Talk to Eno. Oh.
I'm sorry. This is not my fucking day, dude. Not my day. What's the fucking code? Not you are. Okay. I'm now unemployed, Pog. Yeah, I've had horrible timing with characters today. I might just call it quits on RP today. I was gonna take a break and come back, but that wasn't a good idea. I should have just stayed and done other shit. It happens. Yeah, we're fucked. Yeah, let's do something else. Over it. Over it, chat. I'm glad everybody else is having a dope time, though. Tomorrow will be better. We'll see. Have I done any runs lately? No. It's been a slow few days for everyone. No, it seems everybody's having some dope fucking times. It's just, you know, it's the same issue I was having before. You know, it's hard to tell. I might just be over it. I mean, I just need to time it right, and maybe I'll only head into GTRP when it's when the timing is right. I gotta look at the state of the server and what's going on. So might just wait until casino day. Because all it does is it puts me in a bad mood. It puts me in a bad mood when I get on the server and I'm like directionless. I have an idea of the kind of roleplay I want to do, and it's just unfulfilled. It's unfulfilled every time. It feels like the roleplay is happening around me, but I'm not in it. Gordon Ramsay never gets old, though. I should have just kept fucking doing React shit today. So, I'm sorry, guys. I'm sorry today was fucking shit. Mehdi and Hassan haven't really had anything to do. I mean, at least they have, you know, they can talk things up and talk to each other and make plans and stuff. I just look recently and I'm like, I either fucking suck or it's just not my timing's wrong.
Hello.
I'll get over it. Yeah. Thank you. I'm glad everybody else is having fun.
Wow. Is this how it's normally served?
Yes.
In a to-go box?
Yes.
You pay $800 a night to stay here, and you've got to eat your food out of boxes and plastic containers. Are we short of soup? Because it's not even half full.
That's how they serve it.
That's how they serve it. That much?
Yes. Wow. It's one cup.
It's like a retirement home. Is that luxury, do you think?
No, not at all.
What would you rather do? Sip that out of a cup?
Of course.
Jeez, we barely got half a cup.
Yummy.
Anyway, I'm digging.
If there's anything else I can do for you, just go ahead and let us know, okay?
Brilliant. Darling?
I'm sorry?
You can take that now. It's finished. Thank you.
My pleasure.
A chicken parmesan slider. That's dreadful.
That's dreadful.
Now I know why they got the boxes. It's a takeaway puke box. Pizza.
Miss Otto on Joe and Miss Rooster shit as Uchi. Yeah, today fucking sucked for me.
Where are the crab cakes?
Bro, it always comes back to this motherfucker. All the time, man. If I see his face one more fucking time, I'm never watching Kitchen Nightmares ever again. It's always that dude. Well, we could internet historian it, because I know we needed to do that. What the fuck? 1897 footage? Holy shit. 1897? What the fuck? Bro, that guy ate shit. This is so weird. 1895? I like this kind of shit. What the fuck? These must have been wealthy people.
My balls!
Much love. You always find a way to entertain.
Yo, Gyro, thank you very much. I'm sorry RP sucked with me today, chat. I feel bad. I feel frustrated and bad about it. We did have a good conversation, though, with Nico. That was good fun. This is crazy, dude. Bro, how is Venice a thing? You know? Leo and James, I'm out of RP mood. I'm done for the night. What the fuck? Okay, we're not gonna go down this rabbit hole. Chat loves Internet Historian. Maybe we'll do that. In the fall of 76. The failure of DashCon, world's first Tumblr convention, the fill of Rainforest, the failure of Fire Festival, I've already watched enough about that, the ingoodening of No Man's Sky, is No Man's Sky a good one? It's wholesome? The Great iPhone Massacre. Kony 2012. I want to see recent ones. Dude, Cecil Hotel? Bro, I used to live a block away from Cecil Hotel. Navaris. Oh man, so much work goes into these videos that they're uploaded just a few each year, huh? Okay. Hello?
Sponsored by that game everyone loves. Scientists are racing to unlock...
Holy shit, 53 minutes, chat. I'm not high enough yet to commit to that. I mean, chat, 53 minutes. That's a fat fucking commitment. That's like late night. That's like late night vibes. It's only 9 p.m. That's weird, Jux. Oh my god, I don't know what to do right now. I'm a shitty streamer. I need to watch something that really, is fucking intense right now. I either need to watch something really, really cringe or something really, really awesome. And I'm leaning on cringe. Top anime fight scenes. 2001 anime convention compilations. Stolen Valor confrontation. No, that's actually too cringe. I can't do Stolen Valor compilations. That's actually Cringe Fest 5000. It really is. TikTok is so huge that the cringe compilations aren't even really dope now. V-Day in Europe? Lost German girl? What the fuck? 1940, bro. I always get got with this shit. 1945? Bro. Jesus. These algorithms. No, I don't want to watch this. We've already watched this. No. Gus Johnson, not really my style. My addiction, coffee enemas. That's kind of sort of a dance game scenario, isn't it? No. Chat, I don't know. I am just brain dead tonight.
River rocking, an American beast.
The fail RP threw my head out.
Alright, where's the reception?
I'm sorry, Stoned. Ramsey makes me happy.
Jeez. Right. Anyone in? It's like a hallway, not a check-in desk, unless she's behind there. Hello, hello. Somebody's ashes are down there. Bloody hell. Oof. Just like my granddad's house. Hello. Where's the reception?
This is it, basically. This is it. The reception should be out in a minute. If you like, I'll shave it for you.
Thank you very much.
Well, hello.
Nice to see you.
It's nice to see you. I'm Karen Loshon. It's a pleasure to meet you.
I was a little bit nervous then. You know,
you were nervous?
Yeah, honestly, because I was just like standing here on my own.
Well, I'm sorry. I apologize for that.
It's confusing. Where's the reception desk?
It's right here.
Right.
This is the reception desk. Follow me this way.
Okay.
Okay. How old is this place?
This hotel was built around 1880s.
I take it was decorated in
1880s. Bro, this better not be this
way.
For the first time and the last time.
It's been a while for the rooms. There is a closet over here.
Are they special hangers just for me?
Yep.
No, thank you.
Wow.
I think the coat will stay.
Okay. Just check my view. Ugh, look at all those bugs. And the blue bottle is stained for the week. Ugh. There's like a little forest of them down here. Will you give these to your cleaner? Sorry. Ugh. It's like an insect funeral home. And look at this here.
I think that's a cockroach.
To welcome me on the toilet.
No way.
Having a number two.
I'm just like, I can't believe it.
Look at that. Never had a cockroach committee welcome me on the John. Let's get out of here. And how would you rate the food, 1 to 10?
7 or 8.
And if I asked you to rate your rooms out of 10, what would you give them?
4 or 5.
I'm now shitting myself.
You guessed as good as mine.
Dinner.
let's hope that the food is better than the rooms.
Sure.
The concept of an American bistro serving fresh local food in a country inn makes perfect sense. But I can't make any sense of this menu.
So I'm getting a little bit confused because we've gone Mexican on the quesadilla, we've jumped down to Thailand, and then we've gone Italian for the calamari. American bistro?
Yes, sir.
Wow. What would you recommend on the menu?
We do a house-smoked trout. I believe that it's a golden trout from Northern California. Comes in frozen.
You're recommending that I eat frozen trout from Northern California?
You know, Chef, it's been only frozen once, right?
Your head is sweating.
It's a little hot in here, sir.
You're dripping, yeah.
It's me, I'm sorry, Chef.
No, I feel like I got a leak in my fucking bum.
I'm dying.
It's your bald head.
Yikes.
Who puts these ideas together?
That would be Kenny, Chef.
Okay, so give me a Thai sampler plate.
Yes, sir.
Yeah? Entree, dying to see that. Pork
the Valvestano? Yeah. The Thai sampler, Chef.
Are they made in-house?
No, they are not.
No. Thank you, James.
Fuck? The fuck is those sticks?
Wow. It's just frozen crap, reheated, and how can you make a slice of chicken look so bland? I wouldn't give that Thai experience to my fucking dog.
The menu at the River Rock is pretty much outdated. It's Kenny's menu. It's been here for years. I don't agree with the menu, but he's my boss. He pays my salary, and still, you know, get to that point where you're just kind of burnt out.
True. Sometimes you just gotta listen to the big man upstairs, Chad.
Jesus Christ almighty. It's like someone's just dropped a fucking T-Rex foot on my plate.
Holy That's the Valdestano, Chef.
Honestly.
In fact, that might be a small Valdestano, Chef.
Oh, that's a small one?
Yes, sir.
Holy shit.
Ken, the owner, looks like a zombie, sleepwalking towards disaster. It's time to get everyone together and see if I can wake Ken up.
How much money are you losing per month?
Right now, about 5,000 to 7,000 a month.
And that's on the decline?
Correct.
If those rooms aren't that busy, why are they so disgustingly dirty?
They're dirty because I didn't check them.
It's almost like we're robbing customers. When I arrived, you gave your food 7 or 8 out of 10.
Yes.
But the food was dreadful.
No!
Seth, how long have you been cooking?
No, it isn't!
As a chef, 18
no,
years...
No, it isn't!
Are you proud of what you serve?
Personally, I don't agree. It's Kenny's menu. It's on the menu.
I honestly think that Kenny needs somebody to open his eyes so that he can see that everybody that works for him is capable and we're dependable and we're here to help him increase his business and make it successful, and nobody's here to hurt him.
I'm here to help. And it's not as if you're the captain of the Titanic, you're the fucking iceberg.
Ooh.
You haven't stared at yourself long enough in the mirror and actually understood where the issues are. You're looking at them. Good night. Jesus.
I've had about all I can take for one day.
Is that the beef Wellington? I love myself a beef Wellington. I would love this one. That's right. I've seen Ray before. Bro, I just love Gordon Ramsay. I'm fucking sorry, guys. All right? I love Gordon Ramsay. Fucking sue me. Ooh, I'm going to be watching this one, actually, later. I love watching it. In my free time, I love watching old LA videos.
Right, what would you recommend?
I recommend our crab and artichoke dip.
Okay, let's go for one of those.
All right.
Phillips Triple Tower.
Yes.
What's that?
It's a three-tiered tower of three different appetizers.
And is his name big enough on the menu there? Obviously suffering from small man syndrome. Let's go for that. And then the
bassinet
ravioli. Let's try that.
All right.
Thanks, Debbie. Nice to see
you. So the appetizers first, please.
Okay. Well, I'm feeling really nervous about cooking for Gordon. They're all fucking froze together.
Most of the food is prepackaged or canned or frozen because Ginger and Philip are running this place like real misers. They pinch a penny on every corner.
This is our crab and artichoke dip. It's served with deep fried pita bread.
And is it fresh crab or canned?
Frozen Chilean crab.
Frozen Chilean crab?
Correct.
Jesus Christ. Fucking snot dip.
Ew.
I mean, it's like a dish ready for one of Philip's girlfriends. No teeth.
Oh, God.
It's got a sour taste to it. I don't know what it is. no, Jesus. Thanks, darling.
You're welcome. Ah.
He felt it tasted sour.
It always got that taste to me. I don't like it.
You are kidding me.
The
dude, I want to see Guy Fieri do the same thing that Gordon Ramsay does.
Holy mackerel, so...
What is this? Yeah. Why are you cooking this like this?
In your fucking garden, not in your restaurant. Are those shrimp, are they fresh or are they frozen?
They're frozen.
They're frozen, damn. Fucking disgusting. And what's in here?
They're teriyaki beef tips.
Jesus. That sauce is hideous. And that's just tough. Beef tips, it's like beef chew. And that middle one's another portion of snot dip. I'll skip that.
Well, unfortunately for the chef, he doesn't get to dictate his own menu.
What?
What?
The chef doesn't write his own menu?
Who does?
He does not.
Let's move on, shall we? My God, careful.
She just snitched.
So Philip's dictating the menu. I suppose if his staff can't be trusted to clock in and out, they can't be trusted to choose the food.
Feedback on that?
The meat is too tough. The sauce tastes weird. He can tell it's not homemade.
Is this Ramsay's?
And it is. The meat is too tough.
Yeah.
He's getting a full picture, and that's just what I wanted.
Right.
Feel very good about it. I am very disappointed with Dan's food.
It's horrible.
I just hope that Gordon sees the problems with the staff.
Ravioli.
I'm dreading bringing this dish out to him right now, the butternut ravioli.
Thank you. Who made the raviolis?
I don't know the name of the manufacturer.
Manufacturer?
Correct.
So the raviolis aren't even made either?
They are not made here.
Oh, Jesus.
They're packaged.
Oh, shit.
That's dreadful. Like a mouthful of sugar every time. Oh, dear. Thank you, Dane. Wow.
Frozen crab, frozen shrimp, pre-packaged ravioli. It's more like eating a badly run old folks' home than a decent restaurant.
Obviously from a package.
We all knew that one was coming.
I think there's a better way that our kitchen can function than it's functioning right now. I see.
Damn, what a look.
Blatant neglect.
Tell me about Philip's management style.
Well, when he's sober, I get along with him just fine. When he's drinking, I avoid him at all costs.
Uh-oh, shit's about to get real!
On a scale of 1 to 10, how bad is he drinking now?
A 10.
A 10?
Woo!
This week, he was arrested.
For what?
DUI.
You are fucking kidding me.
I'm not kidding.
That's not good.
I want to see the hotel owner jailed. Jailed?
He was kept overnight in jail.
Bloody hell. Why would he not tell me that when it just happened? Hours ago.
Philip's in denial. He doesn't take responsibility for his drinking problem. And I felt Gordon needed to know.
Shit. The truth is starting to come out. Why don't you ask the chef to come out of the dining room? I'd like to meet him. And bring Philip and Ginger as well.
Sorry to hear about your friend, Chief.
He would like to see you all in the dining room.
Boiling Point? Does Gordon Ramsay have any new shows, chat? I really love... I've seen some new stuff.
I'm lost for words. Chef, that was dreadful. I don't think anything was fresh.
It takes extra time to do things homemade.
Yeah, naturally.
We're on a time restraint.
What?
Ask how many hours they get in a week or whatever.
You fucking lost your mind!
My prep cook gets 20 hours a week.
That's not enough time to make fresh food. Is that why all the food's frozen?
I mean, I get cut carrots or cut celery in the bag. I get the boiled eggs in a bag, done, peeled.
You buy in boiled eggs?
Yes.
I played the safe card and purchased most of it prepared.
Played the safe card? We can't even boil a fucking egg in here. Philip, if you care about quality, you need to pay people to prep fresh food, not buy it in.
Krug. Collections, my man. Thank you very much.
I'd have 12, 16 hours a week.
A week?
Yeah.
How'd you survive? 3 hours a day?
Not very well, but
do you have a family?
Yes, I do.
Dan?
7 kids.
This is insane. You can't run this hotel like a miser. If I sold fucking 3 of those cars and put it into the kitchen budget to function for the next 12 months, the chefs can do their job. And speaking of cars, why don't you tell me about this?
Chat, you're just jealous because he's been reproducing, okay? Oh. Oh, Shit. Need to change title? Okay. Poggers. I'm Preggers. Here we go. So that's a pretty decent title. What is this? Here in 10 years. What the fuck is this? Handyman. What? Why is this me? Hey, we went up to 1.3 members. Weeb antagonist. Okay. All right. I'll check this tomorrow. I'm gonna preserve that content for tomorrow. Okay. Chat, what is some good fucking content? Dude, I miss when the algorithm actually worked. You know? It doesn't work anymore. It just shows me what I've already watched. Johnny Sins, bro, that's such a great idea. No, and not something chill, chat. I'm looking for something that's going to be top notch. Something that, you know, will trigger a good response from me. You know what I mean? Primitive technology. I mean, usually things that trigger me are things that piss me off. Mary-Kate and Ashley, what? Edge of your seat shit? I mean, if that's war Omega stuff, I don't know if... There's no war shown? Okay. Edge of my sheet. Okay, let's edge of my sheet. What is this? 15 minutes. Okay. Okay. The intent of this video is to inform, not encourage harassment of any individual member. Please be respectful.
In the modern age of the internet, there is a vast reservoir of resources available for individuals to teach themselves new skills.
Okay.
You could learn how to cook, how to sew, you could even teach yourself calculus. But how far could one take this virtual...
I could not. I cannot teach myself calculus.
Do-it-yourself style of learning.
Chat, how many of you could teach yourself calculus?
Could one teach themselves how to engage in real warfare in a third world country? Could one learn to perform medical procedures on injured combatants from watching YouTube tutorials? Could one prepare themselves to
simply Call of Duty and I'm good to go.
And start fighting with no military experience whatsoever? Although many would vehemently answer no to most, if not all, of these questions, there's at least one individual who would beg to differ. This is the story of Kevin Dawes, the internet's self-taught soldier.
All right. Okay.
Many knew Kevin by his online persona, Caro. He became popular on the forums of the satire website Something Awful around 2010. He was a controversial poster who found himself regularly probated and banned for expressing anti-police, anti-government sentiment, along with...
Does anybody have any experience with CIA field agents? Can you tell me why they're so mentally crooked? The common feature seems to be childlike sociopath and their actions are governed by only virtue of blah, 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 blah.
His insistence that he was being hunted by the CIA.
Okay.
I am being hunted by a national scale police CI team for unknown reasons, Kevin posted.
I really like her voice.
They have followed me for years, destroying my life in a very vicious and systematic fashion. Much of what Kevin had...
She sounds like American Psycho, but female.
...had to say about police and the CIA was startling, revealing an imagination for violence. You really don't want to know any CIA agents, he wrote. Just remember there are always...
She talks like Patrick Bateman, but female.
What if you took a large bore IV catheter and jammed it into a major vein artery, and then motorboated it with your mouth until they complied? You don't run a large risk of killing them unless you've put about 20 cc's of Embulus into their circulatory system.
Okay,
calm
down.
Most members on the Something Awful forums regarded him as a troubled young man who was experiencing symptoms of paranoia.
Okay.
Although, according to Caro, he was mentally healthy and had been told so by medical professionals.
Okay,
when asked how he planned to protect himself from his CIA pursuers, he laid out plans for what could only be described as a superhero uniform.
Okay.
Where he would use forklift fuel cells to design an Iron Man suit.
I've done that before.
Not a costume, an Iron Man suit.
Yeah, I've done that before.
He also devised a mind control satellite, which would induce insanity in anyone he chose.
As you do.
Combine this with a rifle scope Kevin posted, a camera, image processing to track heads on people, and high angular precision, and you've got yourself a crazy person machine. Anyone I use it on would simply end up in a mental health facility. Oftentimes, attempts to debate or...
So this guy is completely sane, and we understand that now.
...argue with Kevin would be met with a challenge to a physical altercation or an accusation of working for the CIA. Anyone familiar with the social dynamics of online message boards...
Sounds like a totally normal person.
...knows that this type of response only invites further provocation. It likely goes without saying that Kevin became a source of mockery on the forums. However, many users continue to urge Kevin to seek the psychiatric help he clearly needed. Although his mental health was regularly called into question, one thing that was totally clear was that Kevin was fully confident in his own abilities. And it was with this hubris that Kevin got himself into trouble. The following year, in 2011, Kevin appeared in a Something Awful discussion regarding the Libyan Revolution. He was posting under a different username due to his previous account.
Yeah, I will be doing the Mario runs next month.
In this discussion, he detailed his plans to fly to Libya in order to gather close quarters footage of the conflict. Apparently, he now considered himself a war journalist.
Call me Raptor Man. And yes, I have Chem gear in a full-sized medic bag in addition to my helmet and OTV, complete with lethal four plates. The four lines, or the IV plate, IV or four? Well, nobody else to practice on, and after they blew up Tim Hetherington and Chris Hondros, the rest repo people, I felt it was prudent. I'm pretty good at it now and feel that I can manage blast. Gunshot trauma and the accompanying hypovolemia. I'm wearing everything in the photo taken with the SLR. I can do pull-ups with that shit on, move around quickly, etc. All that PT personal training paid off. Alexa, silence. Alexa, set an alarm an hour from now.
1 hour.
This guy is crazy. This guy is crazy. None of this makes sense. And I'm so sorry to break it to you, but it is time for the advertisements to be played. All of you non-subs, make yourself apparent. Type one in chat. All of you non-subs, let it be. Let reveal yourself to us. Reveal yourself to us. Your great sacrifice is now. We appreciate your service. Unfortunately, the ads must be played. And under the circumstances in which you get a sub or subscribe, just refresh. We will return in a second. Now it's just me and the subs. How's it going, guys? How you doing? You doing pretty good?
My balls!
Anal champs? Any anal champs? Pog. Oh, wait. Anal champ. Pussy champ. 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 Anal champ. This is a little sexy, isn't it? Hear from Soda Pop, and what does anal champ mean? Sally, anal champ means whatever you want it to. Thank you. Let me know when you guys are back from the ads. I miss hanging out with Nick Pollum. All right, let's go.
Just protective gear, as well as a fully stocked medic bag complete with IV lines in preparation for the trip. Although some brave journalists were documenting the Libyan crisis, the members of Something Awful knew Kevin to be mentally unstable, prone to impulsivity, and lapses in judgment.
Okay.
After all, this was the same person who only months before had described making an Iron Man suit and an insanity beam to protect himself from CIA stalkers.
I wonder how he made the insanity beam.
Before tried talking sense into him. You are in no way qualified to be a war reporter, one user warned. Don't do this, Caro. You're seriously going to die if you try this, another pleaded, and not from CIA mind control drones either. Kevin responded flippantly, "This is happening. Deal with it." When asked if he had any experience in war zones, Kevin replied, "Live leak." When asked where he became qualified as an infield medic, he stated that he'd watched YouTube tutorials. It wasn't just his inexperience that alarmed his fellow forum members. It was his overconfidence, his naivete, his delusions of grandiosity which raised the reddest of flags. He summed up his attitude by writing the following. But try as they might, Kevin
would
not
be dissuaded. The way he types is like a crazy person.
So the members of Something Awful simply wished him luck. In turn, he urged them to keep an eye on his YouTube channel, where he would be uploading his experiences.
What?
Less than a month later, posting under yet another username, Kevin checked in with the forums, confirming his arrival and...
I'm still alive. Made it to Misrata. Doing good. Check the YouTube station. Promoban me if you want. The videos have to get out. My procedure is good. I actually practiced before leaving San Diego. I made it to Misrata on a fishing boat loaded so full of munitions that it almost fucking sank in a storm. We ignore the NATO blockade. Scary fucking radio challenges. There's a video of frigate cruising up to us, glossing our deck. We had SCZU and twin 12.5 millimeter towed gun. All right. Interesting. Libya. Weird.
I'm still alive, he wrote. Made it to Misrata. Doing good. Check the YouTube station.
Okay.
His YouTube uploads, most of which unfortunately have since been removed, serve as a video diary of his experiences falling in with a group of rebel fighters.
Holy
arming
shit.
Arming himself with a sniper rifle and actively fighting the enemy.
All right, I take it back. They ceased firing because NATO showed up and started bombing them. Yeah, we're okay. We're getting some light, small arms, fire.
Where'd he get all this
light
stuff?
Light shelling, nothing compared to earlier. Minor injuries, the heaviest casualties you saw me go with.
Where'd he get all this gear?
All in all, not a bad day. Got one.
It's unclear why Kevin saw the Libyan war as his cause to fight. Perhaps he noticed parallels between his own experiences with CIA gang stalking and the Libyan government's treatment of its political dissenters. Or, as some theorize, maybe Kevin was an adrenaline junkie, looking for an excuse to fulfill his violent fantasies. I'm not going to make a judgment on this, as I simply don't know. But what is known is that his pretext of journalism quickly dropped away, and Kevin was soon actively engaging in warfare and even claiming to have acquired a kill count.
Okay, just had my first sniper versus RPG guy duel. That motherfucker got close. I hope I put one in his ass. But I doubt it. Right now, I've just shown his position to every single heavy gunner here, and we're about to erase him. Good times. Let's see if I can get that spot again.
Not only this, but Kevin Holy stated shit. That he was performing surgery on fellow injured combatants. Oh, and that surgery, he wrote, I performed it under some watchful eyes.
This isn't LARPing anymore, chat. This is, This is real life. I mean, you leave LARP the moment you're not role-playing anymore.
I'm medic qualified.
I mean, he might still knowing be kind of role-playing well in his head Kevin or something. I don't know. Medic
qualified, the Something Awful forms were beginning to realize how dangerous Kevin could be, not only to himself but to others. This became especially salient when Kevin removed a tourniquet on an injured person and replaced it with, quote, one of my much better tourniquets. Responses included, you are absolutely insane, and the best case scenario is that you die before you kill others. Okay. And get help, you schizophrenic lunatic. Ignoring the naysayers, accusing them of being CIA and the like, Kevin continued to fight.
There are a lot of people in the military that have this mentality.
He even landed an interview with NPR.
Kevin admits he's not clear about the chain of command between units and which authority he's under, but he says he has one precious skill that served him well during the battle for CERT.
I work counter sniper. Actually, I watch windows and take out people clinking at us.
Kevin says he was never in the U.S. military, but he does have 10 years of experience as a trained marksman. One NTC fighter has privately tagged
Kevin
as more tourists type. Others believe he's a CIA agent. Kevin says he gets that a lot, but his reasons for being here are actually much more banal.
I get that a lot.
See the world, experience new things, get in way over my head, but, you know, ultimately survive.
The interviewer's glorified treatment of Kevin garnered criticism from Salon, where they dismissed Kevin as an internet troll and a war tourist. But as war tourism in Libya would soon come to an end, in 2011, Muammar Gaddafi, the Prime Minister of Libya, was assassinated, ending the civil war. Having received only minor injuries, including burns and some shrapnel to his shoulder, Kevin returned to his hometown of San Diego. Kevin returned to the States broke, having spent all his money traveling to and from Libya, as well as accumulating credit
Holy
card
shit.
Debt to the tune of $40,000. He set up a Kickstarter to fund his efforts, but only managed to raise $30.
What?
Having been permanently banned from Something Awful by a moderator who told him to seek professional psychiatric help and get back on meds, do it soon before you get yourself or an innocent person killed. Most of what is known about Kevin during this time is written in an article by GQ, which I'll link in the description below. According to the article, he continued to speak privately with Something Awful forum member Brown Moses, expressing his desire to repeat his Libyan adventure in Syria, which at the time was under their own civil war. Occupied by extremist groups such as Al-Qaeda and ISIS, freelance war journalists were being captured and kidnapped with some regularity in Syria. Kevin had survived Libya, but this was much different. Brown Moses urged him not to go through with it, but similar to his Libyan escapade, Kevin would not be dissuaded. It wasn't long after Kevin arrived at his destination that communications with him went
Where'd he get money
dark.
To go for this,
his
if,
usual
even if he was broke?
On YouTube and Twitter, as well as messages to his friends, had suddenly stopped. People grew worried about him, and it wasn't long until their fears were confirmed, as Kevin was officially registered as a missing person in the FBI database. Kevin Patrick Dawes is a freelance photographer who traveled to Syria in September 2012 via Turkey. The last known contact with Dawes was in October of 2012. The consensus on the Something Awful forums was that Kevin was likely dead, either having been killed in battle or captured by extremists. It seemed probable that they would never hear from him again. Posters chose to reflect on him in different ways. Carol fought for what he believed in. He tried to make a difference in life. He did not choose the path of least resistance, he chose to fight, and he died a warrior's death. Caro had a mental disorder and paid his life for not getting treatment. The forums had their period of remembrance. Some regarded him as heroic while others simply insane, and as some pointed out, maybe the two weren't mutually exclusive. And although there was a glimmer of hope that Kevin was still out there, the overall attitude was that the unhinged forum member known as Caro was gone.
But then, something came up.
But on April of 2016, almost 4 years after his disappearance, news broke that Kevin Dawes was alive.
U.S. freelance photographer Kevin Patrick Dawes finds freedom after 4 years in Syrian captivity.
Holy American shit. Freelance photographer Kevin Dawes is free. He was abducted in Syria in October of 2012.
Soon after flying into Turkey, Kevin was denied entry into Syria, but snuck across the border via a circuitous route. Once in Syria, Kevin was stopped at a roadblock, captured, and thrown into a prison camp.
Oh my God.
According to an article in the Washington Post, John Kerry, the Secretary of State under the Obama administration, was personally responsible for negotiating his release. The forms were ecstatic. This was unexpected news, to say the least. Many couldn't wait for Caro to reappear in the discussions and relay his
experiences. That would be insane.
But after returning home, Kevin remained relatively quiet. No YouTube uploads, no Twitter posts, no forum activity. Although he did start a blog, which begins, "My name is Kevin Dawes, and I am a freelance battlefield photojournalist. In October of 2012, I was captured by forces loyal to Bashar al-Assad after crossing illegally from Turkey into Syria. I was held for 3.5 years. This is my narrative of those events." I'll leave a link to his full blog in the description below. The legacy Kevin has carved for himself is a divided one. Some applaud his bravery. After all, he's dedicated much of his adult life to fighting for causes he's believed in, at an unfathomable personal cost. Others cite him as reckless, disturbed, prone to violence, claiming his actions should not be held in esteem, nor should anyone be encouraged to emulate him. The most pressing question many have is, why? Why did Kevin do the things he did? Did it come from a genuine desire to help? Was he looking for fame? Or was he chasing a violent thrill? Perhaps it was a combination of all three. As many have stated, Kevin likely needed professional help.
Holy
shit. And
now that
he's back home, hopefully he is able to get it. But regardless of how you interpret his drastic actions, there's no doubt that he captured the attention of the world. He's had articles written about him by Salon, GQ, Washington Post, just to name a few, and his exploits are regularly referenced on online forums as one of the most surreal sagas to unfold in the French
world. That is insane. Bro, whatever happened to Phoenix Jones, the real-life superhero, dude? I always wondered that. Bro, I used to watch Phoenix Jones videos.
Across the world, hundreds of individuals are patrolling the streets of their hometowns, seeking out injustices where they might be of service. Some are looking for crime to document, report, or in rare cases, intervene. Others are simply hoping to inspire their community with small acts of heroism, such as handing out food to the hungry or giving a car ride to a would-be drunk driver. As homage to their comic book inspirations, they adopt colorful costumes and pseudonyms, like Redbud Woman and the Crimson Canuck. Each has a different MO. Polar Man travels the streets of Canada, shoveling snow from driveways. The DC Guardian patrols the United States Capitol, handing out copies of the Constitution. Most consider their efforts a type of inspirational cosplay, with a bit of live-action roleplay included for theatrical effect.
Okay.
But of those who have truly modeled themselves after their fictional counterparts, who devote their lives to martial arts training, push their bodies to peak fitness, confront criminals who react violently toward them, and operate alongside a police force who are continuously looking for reasons to get them off the street, there may only be one.
Furthermore, whenever you inject yourself into an issue, there's always the problem that could get worse, and that is people can misconstrue intentions, it can escalate the situation.
Armed with a $10,000 bulletproof suit, a stun baton, 2 million Scoville pepper spray, and a GoPro, Phoenix Jones is perhaps the closest thing to a comic book hero we've ever seen. And during his decade of activity, his fans have watched him transform from hero to anti-hero, and finally, to what he'd fought so long to protect Seattle against.
I guess it's true, what they say. You live long enough as the hero, see yourself become the villain.
A very bad man. I guess.
This is the rise and fall of Phoenix Jones.
Welcome to the best stream ever. Matt Miso, thank you. Okay. Dude, this channel's interesting, dude. This is intense journalism.
His full title is Phoenix Jones, Guardian of Seattle, and his story begins in late 2010 when local news began reporting on a mysterious figure who, nearly every night, disappeared into the hidden room of a comic book shop and emerged in a black and gold costume. In the beginning, the learning curve for what he hoped to accomplish proved steep. Patrolling areas rich with nightlife, Jones would occasionally encounter little more than an obnoxious bar patron who needed calming down. Finding crime was nearly as difficult as fighting it. It was pretty embarrassing, Jones told a reporter of Seattle Met, speaking of his early patrols. I walked around downtown and didn't see any crime. But in January of 2011, Jones began to cut his teeth on the extreme brand of heroics that he would ultimately become known for.
One local man came within seconds of having his car broken into, perhaps stolen, until a superhero came to his rescue.
Holy and shit. He just start sticking it down inside between the window here and the rubber strip.
Dan was calling 911, but help flew in before he finished dialing.
From the right, this guy comes dashing in, just wearing this skin-tight rubber black and golden suit, and starts chasing him away.
The attention Jones got from the incident solidified his niche in crime fighting.
Are you hopping on?
In order to separate himself from the growing community of other real-life superheroes.
Bro, Will, we need to watch these journalism videos together. These are fucking insane. I love this style of stuff, dude.
Precarious situations
I just found this channel.
As he continued, Jones began breaking up street fights, attempting to intimidate drug dealers, and in doing so, incurred many injuries.
But a man held him at gunpoint Saturday night while another kicked him and broke his nose.
It's under my eye over here on this.
I can see your eye, it's all swollen.
But the injuries didn't deter him. He appeared to romanticize the bellicose portrayals of comic book heroes, and he was on his way to becoming one, despite the attempts of Seattle police to dissuade him.
And now police say enough is enough. Someone's gonna end up dead.
Don't insert yourself into those situations. If you see something, call 911.
Law enforcement weren't the only ones to disapprove. Jones was largely condemned by other costume heroes who considered him delusional and worried his efforts would be harmful to their overall reputation.
They just don't look as legit.
For the first time, we have someone who agrees with their overall purpose, but doesn't agree with our methods. Ethan Nolan gifted a tier 1 sub to each and every Edna.
They have given 22 gift subs in the channel.
It's not putting on a super suit and finding bad guys to fight. Real life isn't that way. Real crime fighting doesn't work that way. If you act that way, you're probably going to make things worse.
Jones was certainly an outlier in the real-life superhero community, a community which can be traced back to the 1970s with a charismatic Californian known as Captain Sticky.
Okay.
Retiring in his 20s after inventing corrugated fiberglass, Richard Pesta of San Diego devoted his life to becoming America's first Cape Crusader. Like many after him, Captain Sticky's approach was non-violent.
Dude, Phoenix Jones was a real-life superhero. Kind of like Kick-Ass, who existed in Phoenix. Or no, sorry, not Phoenix. In, I think Seattle. Either Seattle or Portland. And he actually fought crime and like got shot at and stuff like that.
His costume and...
Yeah, you can call in. Call the fuck in!
Yes.
What's up?
Dude, I got stun locked by this video. I was watching. I was immediately pulled in. Okay?
Yeah, bro. The fall of Phoenix Jones. Bro, I used to watch Phoenix Jones when he was actually, like, active.
I remember him. I just didn't know who Captain Sticky was.
I didn't know who Captain Sticky was, too.
Dude, he's the stickiest of the icky. Can you link me this video, and I'll put it on the same time code?
Yeah, sync up with me.
Yes.
Okay, here's the video. I am at 5 minutes and 35 seconds. Yes, I would love your commentary, dude. I just found this channel. Bro, somebody linked me the video I watched before. This is a guy, a kid, who clearly had mental illness on the internet, and he ended up fighting with Syrian and Libyan rebels and ended up in captivity for 4 years and just coming back to San Diego. And he fought in wars.
Sorry, what?
Yeah, he was just like, I'm going to go do this. I'm going to go fight. And he's just some kid. And he went out there and did it. It's insane.
By the way, I'm getting an IRL backpack. So now I really got to come visit.
Yes, 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 yes.
And we should do Iron Chef against Train.
Oh, yeah. That'd be fucking hilarious.
5-5-3-5, right?
Yep. And we will go on and go. All right.
Wait for it. 5-3-5. Okay.
Okay. You ready?
Yes.
All right. Hold on. Fuck. Okay. 3, 2, 1, Go.
An outrageous persona served as bait for the media, who gave him the platform he needed to speak out against injustices, such as the poor conditions of elderly homes or greedy auto mechanics upcharging their less knowledgeable
customers. I love this
customers.
Style of journalism, by the way.
Of the modern era, yeah. Many cite Master Legend of Florida.
And I like her voice,
too.
To
seek out crime and
Master Legend.
Holy shit.
Get a taste of that. Next time you want to hurt a little kid.
Patrolling
Oh, yeah. Oh, my God. That's your type of guy right there, isn't it?
Master Legend comes
out. Yeah, I love this guy.
Master Blaster.
Oh, the homemade right. cannon that fires Master Blaster. Filled with cayenne pepper. Who runs Bartertown?
Oh, nice.
While Master Legend and Captain Sticky were novelties at their time of arrival,
who runs
in recent
Bart?
Decades, an influx of individuals following in their footsteps began to permeate the streets of metropolitan cities. Mr. Full Moon of Tokyo, Japan.
Oh.
The Black Rat of Sydney, Australia.
Oh.
Holy shit.
The more news outlets reported on these individuals, the more they seemed to crop up.
He calls himself the Shadow Hare.
Names like Asylum, Fool King, and Professor Midnight.
Although often accused of being naive, many of these heroes understand the scope of what they can
I love this background spooky music.
Inside the law.
Yeah.
While ideologies vary within these individuals,
oh, this guy's just giving out water.
Yeah, that's their thing. A lot of superheroes
safe,
didn't actually physically fight crime. They would just go and do what they
and
thought
making
was good.
A difference where one can. But not only did Phoenix Jones stand in stark contrast with his community, he seemed to look down on them. I don't call them real-life superheroes, he told writer John Ronson, who interviewed Jones in an emergency room as he was being treated for a stab wound.
Jesus.
I call them real-life sandwich handlers. But this separation from the community didn't seem to hinder Phoenix. On the contrary, by mid-2011, Phoenix was well on his way to becoming the world's most famous real-life superhero. During his patrols, Jones would be approached for pictures,
he actually looks like a real-life superhero, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does.
Shoutouts.
This is Phoenix Jones. If you're not listening to bass rock, you're foolish right now. Seriously.
And it wasn't long before Phoenix managed to inspire a small coalition of like-minded individuals.
Oh, yeah!
Holy shit!
To join him on
the Justice League!
El Caballero,
yeah,
whose appearance seemed to pay tribute to luchadors, became one of Jones's closest allies.
You're not a wimp if you call 911.
Yeah. Purple Rain, whose focus was
nice.
Domestic assault awareness and prevention,
nice.
Served as strategist and monitored a police radio in order to direct the group to where they might be needed.
Purple
so
Rain.
Website,
Purple Rain.
Reports, so I look and see
would you, Will,
happening.
Would you date a girl who is a superhero
nice
like this?
At,
in a heartbeat.
Say, you know what, this is where
like she's actually convinced.
And that's how we
find crime.
Dude,
I would love
Phoenix
to date a girl's, like,
he
just the secret identity.
Yeah.
They needed to know how to
so then you didn't have to get into all the real life shit.
Yep, true.
She'd just, like,
and
show up in your window.
Sharp with regular training.
Like, at night.
Average police
yeah.
response time in Seattle is 5 minutes.
Blasting through the window.
We're going to try to basically hold off an attacker. Me, Evo being the superhero. We're going to try to keep it going for about 5 minutes is the goal.
Oh. Oh my god! Yo,
by
Phoenix got hair!
Yeah. The group had accumulated around 10 members. With names like Buster Doe, Midnight Jack, and Red Dragon, they were a diverse cast of characters.
My bet's on Red Dragon.
Unified under the leadership of Phoenix
guy.
Jones, they became the Rain City superhero movement.
Damn, imagine if they showed up.
Hey. The Rain City superhero movement.
Pitch Black's gonna go undercover and attempt to make a drug buy.
I don't usually look like this.
And once he sees the drugs or the thing, we're gonna come in and bust him.
Oh damn!
Here's what's going on. We got cameras all over, and we saw what was going on, and we came in here because we saw what's going on. We're not putting up with it anymore. We're tired of it, man. People keep selling drugs in the city, polluting the block, and we're just not putting up with it.
Hey, just a bitch.
It's kind of funny, but I'm dead serious.
Phoenix's approach remained polarizing. As he often invited camera crews to follow him on patrol, some sense Jones cared more about his own celebrity than improving his community. Have you really made the best uses of media attention to further the causes you claim to serve? Fellow Seattle-based hero Ravenblade asked.
Oh no, Ravenblade's digging in.
Have you really acted like a hero?
Not Mr. Ravenblade.
The criticism was largely engulfed by outspoken supporters, who considered Phoenix Jones the first legitimate real-life superhero, a distinction from the costume street performers many had come to associate with the movement.
Oh shit!
Get down! Get down!
Riot shield up! Riot shield up! Get down!
They continued, allegedly chasing down a suspect in a stabbing, even stopping a bus from being hijacked.
Holy shit.
Phoenix and Purple Rain were married, and the two of them together serving as the dual public face of the group seemed to be good PR. Interviewers and media outlets were divided. Some
that's actually insane.
The heroes.
It's about Nightwing and Batgirl, isn't it? I mean, that's what it is. No. It's more about that than anything else, is it not?
Some choosing instead to highlight their accomplishments.
Tell us what happened the night Phoenix saved your life.
A man was getting violent with security at a nightclub. He proceeded to get violent with me and my group of friends. Phoenix ran in and pepper sprayed the guy and defused the entire situation.
How did you hear about it?
The group was earning a bit of respect, and with
Phoenix.
Seattle having a crime rate 126% above the national average, receiving an F rank on AreaVibes.com, the Rain City superhero movement had their work cut out for them. But the interventionist approach the heroes employed often skirted the lines of legality.
Stay right here! Stay down.
The process of a citizen's arrest, which the heroes regularly performed, is a complicated and unpredictable one, as it's often easy
because
to mistake
to
the context of a given situation.
Oh my god.
Jeremy McHenry of MPS Security Services had this to say of the concept of a citizen's arrest. You're going to be sued if you mess up. You can be arrested for making a false arrest. Many understood that Jones's reckless approach would sooner or later catch up with him. So it was no surprise that in late 2011, the inevitable happened.
What? A so-called superhero in Seattle is under arrest.
For killing a guy.
Phoenix and fellow hero Ghost were out on patrol when they witnessed a crowd of people congregating beneath a viaduct. From the distance up the street where the hero stood, it looked like a street fight. Phoenix ran in, shouting to the group to break it up, instructing Ghost to dial 911 as was their protocol. But rather than thanking Phoenix for his assistance, the group turned on him. Phoenix, unable to verbally control the situation, employed the use of his pepper spray. The police arrived soon after, their patience with Jones already spent, and took statements from both parties. According to Jones, what he thought he was running into was an assault. But according
to a police
report,
the
group was, quote, dancing and frolicking around with each other when a masked man came running and shouting toward them, coating the area in pepper spray. The last paragraph of the police report notes that this was the second
dancing
around
Jones,
who had pepper sprayed a group of nightclub patrons some hours earlier. Although Jones was gone by the time the officer arrived at the scene, he described the distinct scent of pepper spray lingering in the air.
We need superheroes now.
The Seattle Police Department decided to make an example out of Phoenix, and he was arrested for assault.
Wait, can he actually go into court with wearing that?
After sitting in a jail cell overnight, Jones made his $3,800 bail and emerged to a team of reporters waiting outside the courthouse. Phoenix welcomed them to congregate around him, and in a move that shocked everyone, he unmasked himself and greeted the cameras for the first time as Benjamin Fodor.
I'm Phoenix Jones. I'm also Ben Fodor. I also protect the city. I also am a
father. My man's hair's dope.
I also am a brother. I'm just like everyone else.
Holy shit.
Born in Texas in 1988, Benjamin Fodor spent time in orphanages before finding a family and relocating to the Pacific Northwest.
The reveal.
Benjamin and his brother Karos both shared a love of fighting. Each pursued competitive mixed martial arts at a young age. According to Tapology.com, Benjamin, who fought under the name Flattop, boasted an impressive amateur record of 11 wins and no losses.
Yeah, he was knocking dudes
out. But whereas
up.
His brother continued into the professional ranks of organizations such as Strikeforce and UFC, his younger brother Benjamin decided to put his skills to more unconventional uses. But aside from the martial arts background, the conditions which stemmed the most well-known real-life superhero couldn't have been more unassuming.
I mean,
Benjamin
to win that many fights, you do have somewhat of
a
grasp of the reality of combat.
Special needs. His origin story goes like this. One morning, Benjamin found his car broken into, his driver's side window shattered, and a black ski mask laying atop the broken glass on the street. His son cutting himself in the glass had to be taken to the emergency room. Phoenix kept the mask, and days later, when a close friend was assaulted outside of a nightclub while a group of spectators watched, too afraid to intervene, Phoenix decided the ski mask would serve as the basis for an alternate identity. A moniker was chosen. The word Phoenix has roots in Greek folklore associated with rebirth. Jones, one of the most common American last names, is meant to represent the notion that ordinary citizens can hold others accountable for their actions. His costume was commissioned from extreme design efforts.
Uchiha Jones. That's why I chose Jones as the last name.
In order to be reinforced with bulletproof and stab-resistant plating.
Holy shit, this is lore, dude. This is fucking lore.
Big lore. This is
deep lore. His earliest attempts at vigilantism, well before he'd attracted any media attention. Confused as to how to begin, Benjamin took to simply brooding on rooftops. One night, upon witnessing a mugging, he climbed down the building's fire escape, a task which took minutes, only to find the criminal long gone by the time he reached the street. He'd purchased a net launcher, reminiscent of the old campy Batman comics.
What?
Contrary to how he'd imagined the usage of this device playing out, Jones ended up trapping himself in it and was spotted by a passing police officer who took the opportunity to laugh and take a few pictures before cutting him loose.
Are you serious?
Early Phoenix Jones also carried with him a grappling hook, which seemed to fit with his persona but had no practical value. You think you're going to scale a building, a friend critiqued? What are you going to do when you get up there? Swoop down? Parachute down? You're not going to have enough distance for the parachute to even open. Although fans appreciated this insight into the man behind the mask, this move proved detrimental to Benjamin personally, as he was subsequently fired from his job at the daycare.
Holy shit.
Custom-made suit was confiscated for evidence.
What?
So why did they confiscate your suit?
Here's a suit. So the politically correct answer is, to do an accurate investigation, we need to have everything that was involved. The fact that your identity was concealed by a supersuit therefore makes it evidence that we need to take to prove that you are the man underneath the suit.
Despite the feedback that he should put his persona of Phoenix Jones to rest, Benjamin doubled down. He had a backup suit, and he was confident the assault charges would be dropped once the video evidence came out. The evidence in question was obtained by videographer Ryan McNamee, who had been documenting the Rain City Heroes' nightly exploits. Based on the title, Phoenix Jones Stops Assault, Ryan's first-hand interpretations of events differ from the reporting police officers. Many
they
of the
are
videos
not dancing.
Seem to also side
they
with
are
Phoenix.
Fighting.
Even Jones's detractors
I know, but that's what the defense. That's what the fucking.
Later
you know, that's what the lawyers say to make him sound crazy. Yeah.
And despite media outlets, both corporate and independent, offering harsh
criticism. Oh God,
over
the Young Turks!
What an idiot! Okay,
that was awesome. That's the girl who's supposed to be helping. She's like, you fucking pepper sprayed me, you idiot!
Phoenix Jones was on his way to unprecedented stardom.
Shit. Bro, what happens to this guy? Toys? And where does this person get this music?
Jones was back with renewed enthusiasm and a steady stream of encouragement from the largest fan base he'd ever had. But on the night of April 22nd, 2012, a tragic and random act of violence would mark a distinct attitude shift in Phoenix and the Rain City superhero movement.
Oh, God. Uh-oh. Oh, no.
It was after midnight. 21-year-old Nicole Westbrook and her boyfriend were walking through Pioneer Square after leaving a comedy show when suddenly shots rang out.
A villain.
Gunshots!
Phoenix, along with Purple Rain and Pitch Black, ran toward the sound.
Jesus.
Jones caught a glimpse of someone in a gray backpack as the potential shooter and followed him on foot for several blocks until police arrived.
There he is. There's the shooter. Backpack running.
Backpack running?
Backpack running.
Backpack running.
Backpack running.
Having been shot through the cheek, Nicole suffered a shattered spine.
Holy shit. An ambulance
rushed her to the hospital where she passed away shortly after. Nicole was not believed to be the intended target. The source of the gunfire was determined to have been a drive-by shooting, leading police to believe the hooded figure the heroes were chasing was the target. The case of Nicole Westbrook remains open to this day,
Jesus.
And anyone with potential information is encouraged to contact the Seattle Police Department. Jones would go on to cite the tragedy as his biggest failure.
And she's up the street and the medics are taking her away. The fire engine drives by and just washes the blood off the sidewalk and it runs down into a drain. And I just keep sitting on the sidewalk at this point. And people start walking by for work and just do their normal everyday life. understand my world has completely changed and everyone else is exactly the same.
This event would continue to ripple throughout Jones's crime-fighting career, especially in his later years. But directly following the tragedy, there was scarcely time to process. Just a week later, Seattle was to host the May Day protest.
May Day mayhem in Seattle. Demonstrations turned violent as thousands of people clogged downtown streets.
Originally in response to poor labor conditions, the May Day protests began in Europe during the late 19th century and persist even today all across the world. Always held on May 1st, these events occasionally escalate in violent and unpredictable ways.
Broken glass, buildings, and cars covered with spray paint. Tonight, downtown Seattle.
Phoenix Jones, along with Midnight Jack and El Caballero, were patrolling the protest, attempting to determine control outburst. When a protester inadvertently revealed a plan to blow up the Seattle courthouse.
The crowd was actually rumoring a bomb blowing up a building?
Yeah, that's what the people with the black mask were rumoring, because they're kind of dumb, and I don't know if they haven't been to Seattle, but they didn't know that I'm not part of their crew. So they just kept telling me stuff.
So you were infiltrating them? They thought because you were...
We were just walking, and they were wearing masks, and we were.
Right, but because you are as dressed up as a superhero, they thought this guy must be into craziness like us.
Exactly.
Perfect.
Phoenix and his colleagues attempted to notify the police, but they didn't seem to take the testimonial seriously.
You hear rumblings of this, and you let the Seattle police know. Tell me how that conversation went.
This is crazy.
I said, excuse me, sir, can I talk to you? And he said, we're busy. And I said, I'm well aware, can I talk to you? He said, yeah, give me a few minutes. Here's my card.
Oh.
And then that was it.
Here's my card? Police officer gave you his card?
Fearing an escalation, they followed the crowd of protesters to the courthouse. And it was there they witnessed rocks and something which was believed to be a failed explosive device being thrown through the glass windows and doors. Knowing Phoenix would be apprehensive to use pepper spray following his assault charge, Midnight Jack opted to be the one to incapacitate the group. When the police arrived, they arrested 8 of the protesters for destruction of public property. The group received their share of disapproving opinions. Gawker reporter Adrian Chin described Phoenix as a combination of Batman and a mall cop. But one of the more entertaining opposers of the Rain City Heroes was a filmmaker named Ryan Corey, who decided the thing the group was truly missing was a villain.
My name is Rex Velvet, the people's villain, if you will. Before you jump to conclusions, let me tell you that I'm a fair negotiator and businessman.
What the fuck is going on?
Until this city is rid of you.
His attempts to bait Phoenix into a campy online rivalry failed, but Ryan Corey, stylizing himself as the villain Rex Velvet, continued,
this is not me,
calling into radio shows while in character, and managed to turn the fake rivalry into a moderately successful
Bro,
series.
How have I never heard
what?
Of this shit?
Phoenix Jones, you have met your match.
Other supervillains joined in. Parody characters which targeted Jones began cropping up across YouTube and other social media.
Mr. Grimm here.
Yo, Phoenix, I done created something now.
Oh, no.
New culture.
What?
But Ryan Corey and others would have to settle for a one-sided online feud. Jones simply took himself too seriously to engage with them.
Rex Velvet is on the other line.
Rex Velvet is on the other line.
The guy who made that promo that you heard.
I encourage, if you guys want to talk to him, you go right ahead. I don't have anything to say to him because I live in the real world, and I don't promote or accept or even acknowledge people who want to do acts of villainy of any kind, even if it's not real.
I told you.
Look at you, Phoenix Jones.
Priorities shifted for Jones in November of that year when a video patrol log went viral, propelling his already budding celebrity into then uncharted territories.
University Way, between 45th and 47th.
He's an MMA fighter, but he puts this dude out.
Not appear to be working just yet.
While on patrol with 4 other local heroes, Phoenix confronted a man punching the window of a parked car and shouting obscenities at the passengers inside. Police arrived shortly after, with the heroes content to let them handle the situation. But after the assailant shouted a racial slur at Phoenix, Jones challenged him to mutual combat.
Well, Washington's a mutual combat state. If you'd like to agree to fight, we can do that if you'd like to.
Oh my god.
Mutual combat laws allow two consenting parties to engage.
Mutual combat!
Often cited as a vestige of dueling, mutual combat remains legal in portions of the United States, such as Washington State and Texas.
What the fuck?
PJ has offered to engage suspect in orange shirt to mutual combat.
Bro, you know you really fucked with a superhero when they asked for mutual combat.
The handshake, and under the supervision of police officers, Phoenix Jones proceeded to knock out his opponent.
He's just chopping his leg out.
Fighting the suspect. Suspect is down.
This video, posted to Phoenix Jones's YouTube channel, garnered widespread reaction and commentary.
Oh, that's when you know you made a mistake.
Yep.
That first leg kick, you see the guy moving around.
Phoenix, that's when you know you made a mistake. Presence were at an all-time high.
That's when you podcasts, know
talk shows, public service announcements. Jones rarely turned down an opportunity.
From the behalf of the Rain City Superhero Movement and Costume Discounters, you guys have a safe and fun Halloween. See you in the streets.
He did a Reddit Ask Me Anything, which was kind of bizarre, but provided insight into the kind of chaotic individual Phoenix was. Leading his fellow heroes into 2013, Jones would experience a brief golden age of heightened popularity, strong relations with police, and a series of disciplined, systematic patrols. But unbeknownst to Phoenix, a hidden fault line was beginning to appear, one which would not only grow to jeopardize the movement, but would foreshadow Phoenix's ultimate and unexpected fall from grace.
Damn.
Dude, he knocked that dude out.
Well, hello, everybody. Welcome to our patrol tonight.
Yes, hello, all four of you.
All right, I am pulling up the crime trends in Seattle lately here so we can see exactly what's going on.
Would you like us to come over there and take a look, babe?
Yeah.
All right, let's go take a look here.
With more fame than any real-life superhero had ever experienced, Jones began to assume a leadership role in not only the local superhero scene, but the national one. In February of 2013, he posted a video to his YouTube channel directly addressing other heroes, setting a strict standard of behavior he expected from them.
This is what's up. There's a lot of superheroes out here who are doing really stupid crap, and eventually we're all going to get shut down. You guys don't realize it, but there's a war going on out there you don't know about. And that war starts with the government not liking unregulated anything in mass numbers. There's 250 of us to 300 of us walking around with absolutely no accountability. It's going to stop pretty much now.
According to Jones, heroes had been patrolling with illegal weapons, regularly breaking laws under...
Wait, that was a ray gun!
Yeah, that was a fucking laser beam, dude.
Phoenix was worried such missteps would cause a nationwide crackdown, potentially ruining the movement for everyone.
Unregulated laser beams?
Get the whole thing together, getting a regimented way to do this. Before we get shut down.
Jones considered his brand of heroics to be one of the few sustainable out there, but his crew was small, and out of 300 heroes operating across the United States, the Rain City branch only accounted for 15. Phoenix unveiled an umbrella organization he referred to as the Alliance, which acted as a registry for heroes where they agreed to several of Jones's rules.
Oh man, this is the plot for Civil War. Yeah.
Yeah, but I came along and I changed the face of real life superhero.
He's lawfully good now.
He's aware of superheroes. When they look at you, they think that you fight crime. That's what they think you do. So whether you want to go out there and hand out a sandwich or not, you're still in danger of being injured. Don't be stupid. Be prepared.
The selection for new recruits in Phoenix's hometown became increasingly rigorous. And in an interview with KIRO Radio, Jones admitted to rejecting 100% of the incoming applications.
The Rain City Superhero Movement is hiring.
Oh no.
And applications are available right now.
So far, I've rejected 6 of the 6 applications I've got. Where they're like, I'm 7 feet tall and super, super buff right now. I don't know if there's a mask that'll fit over my giant meat head, but it's cool. I just want to walk around and punch people. Let's go. And I'm like, no.
At this point, Phoenix had been patrolling the streets almost nightly for nearly 3 years. In the beginning, he was critical of an action, or what he called sandwich handling, but his new focus seemed to be on personal restraint. Although martial arts or military experience remained a prerequisite for joining, Phoenix began to reject people if they showed any inkling of violent tendencies.
I think there are some people in the city who are up to no good and need to be taught a lesson. On the other hand, there are lots of good people in the city who get taken advantage of on a regular basis, and that needs to stop.
Second part of the answer, awesome. First part of the answer worries me. Anytime anyone says needs to be taught a lesson, I get uncomfortable. Your demeanor doesn't strike me as generally violent type. You know, it could be the Clark Kent glasses throwing me off. We don't get to teach lessons. We get
get to stop.
They're
people
basically all
crimes,
the Merman Rider.
The authorities. That
dude, Merman Rider is way sicker than this.
His patrols.
Watch what you say about my Merman Rider.
A weekly
dude.
Schedule was posted with each patrol group consisting of a team leader, a medic, and a radio operator. Phoenix claimed the movement now included a legal team, although to what capacity I'm not sure. Aspiring heroes would be subjected to a probation period, and they would be unable to even choose a name or a costume until they joined in 15 patrols, stopped a violent crime, assisted in a medical situation, ran the GoPro, ran the live stream, and written several patrol logs.
Live
At this
stream.
Point, the team would take a vote to determine whether the applicant became a full member.
With this application, you're extremely underqualified. But the part of it that I do like is it was really well thought out. As far as joining the main group of the RCSM, I think you would probably end up getting hurt.
The majority of video logs on Jones's YouTube channel were uploaded during this period. On the surface, their operation seemed to be running more smoothly than ever. A lawful, by-the-book protocol enforced by Jones, diligent documentation, regular check-ins with the radio operator and other heroes.
I'm close enough to Red to make contact. Should I do that? Over.
And thanks to the generosity of their fans, they were able to record evidence of most encounters, which seemed to result in a much healthier relationship with the Seattle police.
Holy shit.
Floyd. Hey, we have a video of the beginning of those guys over here pretending to flash or even maybe flashing the real gun. And there was a little altercation. I also confiscated some black tar heroin off and threw it down a drain. I got all that on video if you need it. Yeah, I got it on video if you need that.
Recovering stolen bikes, addressing medical concerns others simply ignored, exposing individuals soliciting sex acts from the homeless.
The crazy thing is I got a masked man following me.
Yeah. And, the crazier thing was when you pay a homeless crack addict to suck your dick. That's crazy.
I didn't.
It's on tape.
On slow crime nights,
they Jesus Christ.
In contrast to Jones's previous disparaging remarks. However, things were not quite as harmonious as they seemed. An argument over a helmet, which El Caballero accused Phoenix of stealing, caused his longtime sidekick to abruptly leave the group. But most shocking of all was the sudden departure of Purple Rain. In November, Purple Rain made a social media post stating that she and Jones were separating and
did Phoenix Jones get me too?
Future projects. Purple Rain opted to keep the details of their separation private, a difficult boundary between public and personal life when the two have so much overlap. But her fans seemed to respect her decision. With the loss of his two closest allies, Jones found himself unable to stop a growing mutiny of disgruntled heroes, ready to expose the flaws of their leader and ultimately bring about the end of the Rain City superhero movement for good.
He's an actor.
I just want to beat the fuck out of this guy.
He's not worth it.
God, I'm having one of these moments right now.
Come on.
Oh, shit.
He's struggling to find some good RP.
Although Phoenix's celebrity continued to increase, even landing a cameo in the PlayStation 4 title Infamous Second Son, those who remained close to Jones knew the movement was coming to an end. The domino effect of Purple Rain and El Caballero leaving inspired others to do the same, taking to social media to air grievances about their leader on the way out. In a post that began, Phoenix Jones is a con artist thief, Shockwave leveled some startling accusations against Phoenix. As per Jones's instruction, each hero was required to purchase a bulletproof vest, a payment which they handed directly to Jones, who claimed to have cut a deal with the manufacturer. However, as months went by, no one received their vest. Jones had also been requiring the Rain City heroes to pay him monthly dues for a health insurance plan in case they were hurt on patrol. But many began to suspect there was no such insurance as Jones failed to produce any sort of documentation. Perhaps the most damning of all were the attacks against Jones's integrity as a crime fighter. Phoenix Jones preys on people exiting bars drunken, unable to function normally, Shockwave claimed, citing the Mutual Combat video for evidence. Would MMA allow one fighter to be drunk while the other is sober? Accusations of exaggerating his heroics and spinning the narrative in his favor were nothing new for Phoenix, although until this point they'd come from heroes and spectators outside the Rain City movement. But this was coming from someone who patrolled with Phoenix, who knew what he was like when the livestream was turned off. El Caballero, Shockwave, and Dragon founded a new organization called Echo. They continued to patrol Seattle, regularly making appearances at the recurring May Day protest, but their audience failed to grow to Phoenix-like proportions. In May of 2014, Phoenix Jones announced that the Rain City superhero movement was officially over. Jones's statement didn't address any of the aforementioned accusations, but instead cited other reasons for the disbandment. Certain members cannot run 2.5 miles in 30 minutes, Jones stated, or do 5 pull-ups or 25 sit-ups and believe it's okay to carry illegal weapons. Rex Velvet made a Facebook post celebrating the end of the movement, asking former members to air their dirty laundry about Phoenix for a video he would produce. It's unclear whether any of the former members took Velvet up on his offer, but checking Ryan Corey's YouTube page, it appears no such video has yet been made. Jones, now primarily a solo hero, continued fighting crime in Seattle. His enthusiasm seemed undiminished as the patrol logs on his YouTube channel were uploaded at more or less the same consistency.
Hey, this is Phoenix Jones. Found a guy who was over here at the store, stole some detergent, took off running, clearly homeless. This is the worst part of my job. Stealing is stealing. I'm not gonna let you get away with that, especially detergent. This new way to get high with detergent, I found out. No problem. There's your stuff back, man. No problem. Sorry about that. I hate that kind of stuff, but what can you do, right?
Wow, you guys are like superheroes, right?
Yeah. Yeah, we do like kind of like a neighborhood patrol. But...
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so be safe, man. Thanks. Really sorry that happened to you.
He returned to competitive mixed martial arts, fighting under his alias and often accepting match decisions while in costume.
Vigilante, Phoenix Jones!
Nice!
Holy shit.
A rivalry between his older brother Karos, which has reportedly existed since childhood, made for good promotion for upcoming fights, and the advertisements leaned heavily on the superhero motif Phoenix had cultivated. The majority of his fan base stayed by his side, offering support on social media and YouTube as he continued to break up street fights, catch shoplifters, and even create a database of stolen vehicles in the Seattle area. But the twilight years of the Phoenix Jones character weren't free from controversy, particularly in 2015 when Jones had a comic book series commissioned about himself. The events depicted were based on Jones's patrol logs and personal journal entries. Many classic Jones tales were included, but depictions of the Nicole Westbrook murder seemed in poor taste. As Jones told Seattle
Jesus
radio
Christ.
Host Jason wow. Rance, he'd submitted the comic book to the Jet City Comic Con, where it was originally accepted, but once it was known the events depicted were real, Jones was asked to withdraw it.
No, there were no real major complaints. A couple people came up and just said that, they didn't like it and thought it was too real. And I said, well, if you want to read a fake comic book, get a Batman comic book. If you want to read about my life and you want to help someone and maybe get the case back out in the news and maybe get somebody to know what happened, then read my comic book.
And yet at the same time, a comic book like this opens you up to the criticism that you might be profiting off of the death of someone. How do you respond to that?
I don't know. I mean, I guess I'm just telling my story, and this happens to be a part of my story. And this incident is just so important to the person that I became and the choices that I made.
Nicole Westbrook's sister spoke out in support of the comic, citing that it could raise awareness of the still unsolved case. Phoenix's behavior over the years became stranger and more erratic, such as this incident in 2016 where he claimed to have knocked someone unconscious and left them on the street, opting to tweet at the police rather than call 911. Jones specified that he, quote, left the guy my card so that when he wakes up he can call me if he has a problem. When asked what he meant by his
card,
Jones explained it was a print of this glamour shot, along with the phone number of his attorney. More shocking still was this post to the R Bodycam subreddit, which shows police responding to a former friend of Jones's who'd reported the hero came to his apartment, his knuckles wrapped for a fight, threatening his life.
I guess last night I hit on one of his girlfriends that he didn't like, and he started slandering me all over Facebook, and then he came here threatening me, said he was going to beat me up, piss on my face, and then when she went downstairs to tell him to leave, he said if I didn't come out...
Is that Caballero?
He also said he was going to kill me.
I don't know who that is.
Dead.
I think that's Caballero.
Yeah, he texted him
on,
saying that he would
I have
him
all
around,
on my phone.
He would find him.
And kill me.
So...
Something was clearly happening to Phoenix Jones, and his audience began to see the dark side of his impulsive personality. By February of 2019, Phoenix hadn't uploaded a patrol log to his YouTube channel in 3.5 years. So it wasn't a surprise when he formally announced his intention to take a break from crime fighting. But what was surprising were Jones's cynical reasons for the hiatus. "I don't think people are mostly good," Phoenix wrote. "I don't think I've met enough people I would get shot to save. I don't think people would get shot to save me. I was wrong. Maybe everything I've ever believed in was wrong.
Holy shit.
When asked to reflect on his career, interviewers were met with a Phoenix who was oddly defensive of his legacy and adamant about his distinction from other so-called real-life superheroes.
So how many crimes have any other superheroes other than me stopped in Washington State?
Well, you're the only one I think anybody's aware of, so yeah.
Okay, so then you're asking me a question about superheroes.
Right.
These guys are going to a neighborhood they don't know, dressed in outfits that are not the same, that are not uniform, with skills that are not good.
Tobey Maguire. Food to homeless Holy people. Shit.
I mean, you are a LARPer. You are a LARPer with a bag of food. I am a superhero.
Damn!
Although Phoenix had always displayed a certain degree of bravado, his trademark altruism seemed to have been replaced with resentment and misanthropy.
I put people away. I'm a superhero. I'm the only real one. It's not a joke. It's not a game. We're not talking about the kind of superhero. I'm a real fucking superhero.
Phoenix Jones was retiring with a questionable reputation, but his fans seemed content to remember him for the self-sacrifice of his early years, reassuring him that when he's ready to return, they'll be there to support him. But in January of 2020, shocking news broke that would forever change the public's perception of Phoenix Jones.
Oh, shit.
Phoenix Jones.
Oh, come on.
You're a fucking asshole is what you are. You're not a fucking hero. You're a fucking fraud.
Bloodfinger.
What the fuck?
What'd he do?
Okay, then maybe you should. Are you gonna behave yourself? Tell me you're gonna behave yourself. Say, I'm gonna behave myself. Are you gonna behave yourself?
That's what I do.
Good. So are you gonna behave yourself?
Yes, I will.
Say you're gonna behave yourself.
I'll behave myself.
Thank you. Have a good day.
During the months following Phoenix's retirement, his social media remained active and would even occasionally feature something resembling a video log. Jones seemed reluctant to give up the superhero persona despite
no longer donning
the costume for regular patrols.
I think they're going to lead up
but
to that.
But toward the end of the year came a sudden absence. The videos, the tweets, it all abruptly stopped. Not known for shunning the limelight, Phoenix's drop in activity was unusual. But fans wouldn't know why until 2 months later, when news broke of Phoenix Jones's latest and most unexpected arrest. As articles from the Seattle Times, Newsweek, and many other sources report, in November of 2019, two confidential witnesses approached the Seattle Police Narcotics Division. Phoenix Jones, they claimed, was a drug dealer and had been for some time. Following the tip, a narcotics detective operating under the alias Mike began texting Phoenix with the intent of purchasing $500 worth of MDMA from the former hero. Jones requested $300 be transferred up front to his Venmo account. Days later, Phoenix arrived at the 3rd Avenue Starbucks to meet Mike. The whole interaction took less than a minute as Phoenix exchanged a brown paper bag for the remaining $200 in cash.
What's in there? Is there a cigarette in there? Is that what's buffing it?
Lab testing confirmed the substance in the bag to be what was advertised. The officer arranged a second meeting with Jones, but had trouble following through. Jones would postpone or fail to appear at meeting locations even after accepting an additional $500 via Venmo transfer. A second persona was created, this time a female. Lara was more conversational and appeared impressed when Jones asked her to Google him, revealing that the individual she had agreed to purchase cocaine from was in fact a real-life superhero. After a few days of building rapport, a second meeting was scheduled. And at 11 p.m. on January 9th in the Silver Cloud Hotel, Phoenix Jones was arrested for possession of 4 grams of cocaine packaged with the intent to sell, along with various paraphernalia.
Hey, wait, what are y'all doing? No, I'm trying to catch him.
Yeah. Da-da-da-da! Phoenix Jones, shit! What did I do?
Posters on the R Seattle subreddit claimed to have known about Jones's involvement in such activities for years. Anyone who knew Ben knew about his side hustle, one poster wrote. He's been dealing for years and everyone knew it, wrote another. Many scoffed at the relatively small amounts of narcotics Jones was arrested for dealing. Some pointed out that there were more harmful drugs than MDMA being sold on the streets of Seattle. One poster claimed Jones carried other illicit substances, writing, he once accidentally gave roofies to a friend, telling her it was Molly, which means he keeps it in his inventory. In a podcast titled Super Yourself, Dark Guardian host and longtime critic of Jones interviewed former Rain City superhero Midnight Jack, who appeared saddened yet unsurprised by the news.
I've known Ben for years. Like, we're talking almost 10 years.
You know what I mean? Like, I've been shot at with Ben. I've been in shit. I've been in street fights. I've watched people die next to Ben. Like, I've seen a lot of stuff go down with him. So the fact that this is who he is now is extremely discouraging to me. And if you're a superhero in the Seattle area, it's over for you now. It's done.
As Jones's video logs and interviews attest, exposing drug dealers had been a prominent part of his crime-fighting efforts. Where had the impulse to enforce these ideals been coming from? Midnight Jack gave his interpretation.
How do you think he ended up this way? I think that he thought that this was going to work out. He was going to get really famous over this superhero thing. I think that was always the plan. And don't get me wrong, I don't think that he ever intended to not do his job. Because I remember him being dead focused on his job, dead serious on it. After the Nicole Westbrook shooting, he started to get more distant and darker. Like, maybe that set off something in him.
Midnight Jack corroborated the claims that such activities had been going on for years, with the hero so unabashed he'd been seen dealing while wearing a Phoenix Jones t-shirt. Some found the irony humorous, but many of Jones's fans expressed anger and disappointment at the hypocrisy.
This is a hard one to talk about. Make my mouth dry.
Yeah, it's real sad. Real sad to see someone who kind of like stood up for justice and was a symbol. I mean, I feel like I'm talking about Batman right now, but he was.
Even Jones's arch enemies seemed conflicted in their victory. Phoenix's booking records were posted to Reddit. Jones had been charged with violating the Uniform Controlled Substance Act, denied bail, but given a conditional release. His initial hearing was scheduled for February 3rd. According to the King County records, Jones was found in contempt, spent 11 hours in jail, and released on a $1,000 bail.
Damn.
As of now, information available to public regarding his case ends here. But the blow to Phoenix's reputation appears
critical. Selling drugs, and everybody's turning their back on him.
Heroics would be taken seriously by his remaining audience. It seems, at least for now, that the story of Phoenix Jones has come to its unexpected conclusion.
Jeez. I mean, he was just selling drugs.
Just to get by, just to get high.
Yeah.
Cops, sometimes they arrest the wrong person, right? I've never arrested the wrong person because I see the crime take place. I watch you hurt somebody. I watch you steal this. I watch you do these things. So it's not, to me, it's more exact to justice.
Phoenix Jones has always been a divisive figure. Where his supporters saw bravery, his critics saw misguided recklessness. What many saw as a desire to inspire, others saw as a need for attention. And while his methods and motives are dubious, the influence of Phoenix Jones on the superhero community, despite his repeated attempts to distance himself from it, is difficult to overstate. With more costume heroes on the street now more than ever, many cite Jones as their direct inspiration.
Wow.
The practice has become so widespread that a training camp named the Superhero Foundry has opened in Las Vegas.
Although we should do the Superhero Foundry.
They seem to overemphasize the practicality of knife and tomahawk throwing during patrols. Some have claimed that with the fall of Phoenix Jones, the Seattle branch of the superhero movement is over. According to Midnight Jack, while he and the remaining members
still wiping blood off
acts
of
community service, their nights of wearing masks and bulletproof costumes are finished.
It's over.
Dude, that guy, the friend he threatened to kill, was definitely El Cabrone or whatever.
Yeah. I'm a superhero. Oh, you like Phoenix Jones? You here to sell drugs?
If this is the case, they will be missed. But with a nightly presence on the streets of Seattle spanning a decade, and actions reportedly leading to over 100 arrests.
That's arrest 187, provable 187 for me.
The Rain City superheroes have shown us what an approximation of comic book vigilantes look like, however skewed they may appear in the real world.
Did you hit her in the face, bro?
No, I didn't do nothing, bro.
And it's unlikely the citizens, police, newscasters, and criminals of Washington State will soon forget the sight of black...
Superhero Foundry is shut down.
The hiss of walkie-talkies and the smell of pepper spray. Which marks one of the strangest examples of life imitating art.
I got armor. I went out, I got gear. I got a legal team. Studied the law for 6 months. I treated this like I was going to war.
And forever solidifies the decade Seattle was patrolled by Phoenix Jones and the Rain City superheroes.
If someone swings, everyone's getting pepper sprayed. Think about it before you do it. If y'all swing, someone's getting sprayed. It's better to just walk it off. You got a call on me, right? We don't really need this. This is dumb.
whatever he said he needs. Someone just breaking up fights.
Damn, son.
I'd like to introduce Ryan Probert, who has begun providing original music for the channel. I couldn't be grateful to Ryan for lending his skills to Atrocity Guide. You'll be able to find the score to this video as well as other original music on his YouTube channel, which I'll link along with the social media.
His music is on YouTube.
Damn, son.
Original music.
What are you, even superhero?
Big fucking pog.
Fucking poggers.
Bro, damn. Yeah. Sometime I'm going to have to go through and fucking watch all this content. This channel I just found. Oh, there's only like 6 videos.
Dude, can we talk about something for a second?
Yeah.
On a scale of 1 to infinite poggers, how pogged are you about Diablo 2 Remake coming out?
Bro, it's actually like a dream come true.
I'm hyper pogged right now.
Yeah.
So when is it actually dropping?
I don't think there's an exact month yet. I think it's
gotta be soon. Because next year Diablo 4 comes out, right?
Yep. Yep.
So they're gonna want to have a whole year or so.
I don't think they're gonna touch the audio or music or anything. I think they're just gonna make the game, make it look good, make it look fresh, you know?
Yeah.
It's gonna be sick. Oh, D4 is coming out in 2024.
D4 is coming out in 2024? What?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Yep. So there's some time, dude. I mean, fuck.
But nah, 2024, there's no way. They have too much of that game done already.
If we make it to 2024.
Yeah.
That's why they're reskinning to D2 to keep us tied off in the meantime, dude.
Right.
They've Vincent Sir shall become a superhero. I will wear an El City shirt and disable any and all crime as Austin.
What's that?
Someone says they haven't even released a date for Diablo Immortal, the cell phone Diablo.
Oh, yeah. That's crazy. I never thought there'd be a mobile Diablo game.
Mobilia. All right, so what are you getting into, dude? Doing more reactione?
I don't know. Today's been a long day.
Yeah.
I started at 12:30.
Damn, son.
So I might just call it, dude.
Yeah, and on a high note.
Yeah. I mean...
My balls!
That was sick. Stay a while and listen.
Watching that with you.
That was fun.
That was pog as fuck. What are you going to do?
No idea. I'm just kind of... I'm not gonna lie. I feel like one of the things that's like kind of limiting about GTA RP... is like you if you don't have people to RP with, it kind of feels a little empty.
Oh yeah, riding a bike or a car around the city. Mm-hmm. Yep. It's like it'd be like that sometimes. I mean, that's the thing. It could be hit or miss. Some days it hits hard, and when it does, it's dope as fuck. Other days it's lonely and slow.
Yep.
And when it's lonely and slow, you can't go smash trees. Collect wood. Yeah. Hey, but we're going to be doing this Valheim.
Yeah.
That's going to be good.
I got people who want to go on that.
Yeah. I'm actually very excited about that.
Valheim.
A lot of people seem to be very excited about it.
You want to do that tomorrow?
Yeah, I'll do that tomorrow.
All right, let me send the message out.
Easy clap. Easy clap. Easy fucking clap. Yeah. Yeah.
You ask Vader if he wants to jump in.
Okay. We'll do.
We'll get it cracking.
That'll be Pogfest 5000.
That'll be a mega pog.
Yeah.
Just fighting mythical monsters, dude.
Oh yeah, I'm actually excited to give that a go. I was like fucking brain dead. And last time we played,
I actually had a ton of fun the first time we played. I was like really enjoying it, and then it was tough.
Yeah, but I'm excited. I'm actually very excited to play it. Putting respect on it. Get it going.
You know, grind it with some homies.
You know, Link is on NoPixel.
Oh really?
Yep.
Oh shit! I didn't know that.
Yeah, our character is really cool.
So, silent character.
TTS.
Nice.
Yeah. It's really cool. Okay.
Right.
What'd you do earlier today?
Just kind of kicked it.
Yeah.
I watched the second season of Servant. The Apple Plus show. And it's okay.
Why is it just okay?
M. Night Shyamalan.
Oh, really?
It asks a lot of really cool questions, and it doesn't really do much to answer them. It's a lot like Lost.
Yeah,
but it's cool. Like, if you have nothing to watch, I recommend it highly.
Okay. Well, shit. I do need a new show to watch.
Yeah, I was just kind of fucking off today. I just needed some day of
relaxation. It's such a Sunday.
It's a Sunday.
It's such a fucking Sunday, dude.
Yeah. Sunday morning.
Sunday morning. Yeah, that's why I think I might be done and just chill.
I mean, yeah.
It's been a long day and I want to relax, dude. Take a shower.
Wait, when did you get on?
About 12:30 p.m.
Oh, did you take a break?
Yeah, I took about an hour and a half break. I was just I hit hard. Like, first 5 hours today was fucking dope. Or 4 hours.
Yeah.
And then I needed to take a break. I probably should have just left it at that, but I had a very, very, very good stream earlier today.
Mm-hmm.
And then I went on to RP. I kind of just, my timing wasn't right. So then I ended up getting off both times.
My balls!
Okay. Pump. And it just be that way sometimes.
Yeah, it do just be that way.
So.
All right, I'll let you get some bed. I'm gonna hop on and get some RP in, I think.
All right.
All right, Brozef.
All right, much love, dude. Thanks for watching that with me.
That was fun as hell. All right, talk to you soon, man.
All right. Good night. Big pog, big pog. Chat, I am tired. It's been a day. We still found some good content to watch and come back on. I want to thank you all for your incredible support. Big Killa Beezy, Gosu PvP, Mwah, Mother's Pie, thank you for that dono. Sherbert Sean, my dude, 19 months. You guys are awesome. I am just fucking tired, man. I'm looking forward to getting another early start tomorrow, 1 p.m. or earlier for all the EU motherfuckers. And I hope you guys have a good night. I hope you have sweet dreams. I hope that, you know, I hope you guys come back tomorrow. So, if I get some good rest, hit hard tomorrow. Make sure to check out the Reddit, other socials. You guys are awesome. Good night. Good night, Unix. Good night, everybody. Sweet fucking dreams.